Good morning, Conky. How's it going?
It's going fine.
Oh.
Glad to hear it.
So what's today's thing over, Conky?
Today's secret word is...
fusion.
Now, you all remember what to do whenever anyone says a secret word, right?
Scream!
Right!
For the rest of the day, whenever anyone says a secret word, scream real loud!
Broadcasting from the PLA Situation Room in Roy, New Mexico, you're listening to The Snowplow Show.
Now it's time.
On Prank Call Nation.
Cactus.
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 Cactus. I am playing games.
Cactus.
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 Am I supposed to be doing this?
Cactus.
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 Cactus, this cocksucker.
Cactus.
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 You've got to be crap on my balls.
Cactus.
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 This is going to be a fuck job to edit.
Cactus.
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 You're calling me a hobo.
Cactus.
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 Roy, the retarded boy.
Cactus.
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 How about if I come down and punch your head off?
Cactus.
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 Cactus. You blowing smoke up my ass.
Cactus.
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 You think a tracer can stop me?
Yay, we're here. Hey, Carlito.
Hey.
So this is the Snowplow Show. Today it's Brad and Carlito. I noticed how much people loved having guests on when I had Rappy on, because everyone loved the Rappy Show.
Yeah.
I'm being sarcastic. I don't know if you saw the YouTube comments. They're not nice.
They were very mean about Rappy.
Yeah. Hilariously mean.
Yeah.
I think it hurt Rappy's feelings.
This is YouTube.
Yeah.
YouTube comments are like that, man.
People will always just freak out when I have anyone else on, and they're always mean. They're like mean to you even, but like it was really bad with Rappy.
Wow.
Yeah. Damn people.
Mm-hmm.
You want to flip the coin for today's sponsor?
I don't have a coin.
Ah, shit. All right. Well, we're gonna say it's Devin Gladden is the sponsor. So, if you could write his name down and, like, anytime anything goes wrong, just curse his name.
All right. Trayvon McFadden.
Yeah. Yep. Perfect. Perfect. So today we're going to pay homage to Radio Shack.
Homage.
Homage to Radio Shack. Cause I'm going to miss Radio Shack.
Me too.
Radio Shack was the shit. I mean, they died like 10 years ago, but... as a kid, they were the shit.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I need to play the Didoot song for you. Hold on.
Didoot.
You like the Didoot song?
Oh, yes. Doo-doo-doo. Yeah.
Okay, yeah. So we should do Radio Shack, because Radio Shack's going bankrupt.
We better while we can.
Yeah, it's like Kmart. We wanted to do the layaways... and I didn't end up doing that many over Christmas. But yeah, we got to do Radio Shack before they die.
Yeah!
What are we going to do to Radio Shack? I want to call some Radio Shacks and just laugh at them.
I mean, I would love to call as the corporate office and have them maybe take down some of their displays or something.
Yeah, get them to shut down some stores.
Yeah.
Like, say, we're... I can't remember if I was actually successful with that at Blockbuster. It seems like I was, but then we weren't sure. But then they weren't answering, so maybe.
Mm-hmm.
That would be a lot of fun to just get for a Radio Shack to close up.
Remember, you were able to get some numbers and people that were actually still renting and shit like that.
Yeah, that was fun. It was really hard to do with Blockbuster, because the way their computers worked, they just had to... it was a pain in the ass. Most of the employees, they just couldn't do it.
Dude's like, fuck it.
Yeah, they just had no idea. Even when I tried to walk them through it, they just didn't want to. But the other video store I did, Family Video, they were so easy. Like, they can get me as many numbers as I want. They still would.
Yeah, you got customer numbers too, right?
Yep. We're going to call Radio Shack customers today. And It's going to be hilarious. I've never called a Radio Shack customer.
I'm excited.
And you were telling me yesterday, like Radio Shack was probably the first company, like at least as far as I know, the first company to ask for customer phone numbers and keep them in a database like that.
Yeah, I think at least like around 96, 97 they started, and I was like, what?
I think earlier than that even.
Yeah?
I'm thinking at least early 90s.
Yeah.
Yeah, they would ask for everyone's phone number, and they'd get your address, because they wanted to mail you a catalog and their flyer every month, which was awesome. I loved getting the catalogs and the flyers in the mail.
I just remember being there in the 90s and this lady freaking out about it. She's like, no phone, no phone. Like, I gave my phone out once and blah, 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 blah. And I said, okay, all right.
Yeah, and I found out last night that most of them don't ask for phone numbers anymore because I was trying to get info.
Mm-hmm.
But I swear, like, here in Oregon, like, at least at my local one here in Albany, they always ask for my phone number every time I buy something. And I'm just like, oh, I'd rather not give it to you.
Must be a regional thing, because remember around the early 2000s, an article online saying that they were discontinuing it because of complaints.
Yeah, people were
freaking
out.
And they were saying, but like so many retail stores were doing it, copying the idea already, that it was pointless. But Radio Shack was stopping it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think they were doing it even before Domino's Pizza. Maybe.
Really?
I think. I don't know. Actually, I probably don't know, because like we didn't get our Domino's until the mid 80s where I lived. Like, I don't know when Domino's came around. So how are you feeling? I hear you're sick.
Yeah, I'm going to the doctor after the show. Like, I gotta get a hot beef injection.
What's the problem? Like, you just...
It's like a sinus thing. My wife had it for a while, and I tried to not get it, and I think we shared toothpaste, and I think that's what did it.
Ah, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm expecting to just come down with something really soon, because Rappy's been here all week, and he probably uses my toothbrush. He didn't bring anything with him.
He's a vagrant.
Probably using my razor. I probably have AIDS now.
He used your toothbrush? No, he didn't.
No, I don't know. Like, he sure didn't bring one with him. I think he just does. I don't know. I'm not going to say anything.
He didn't use the rag method?
Huh? I don't know what he does.
Tooth rag?
He probably just drinks so much alcohol that he doesn't need toothpaste. It just the alcohol cleans his teeth.
He just swishes it in his mouth.
He does. Like, I edited so many swishes out of the show that me and him did. Like, every time he took a drink, it was pretty gross.
Well, there you go. That's what he's doing. He's like, goodbye, Talatos.
Fuck toothbrushes. I got beer.
Oh, shit.
good old Rappy. Gotta love him. So what should we do first? You wanna call Radio Shacks? Or?
Yeah, let's call a store. Yeah.
Okay, I didn't even prepare. Let me get on Google Maps.
So I wonder who's going to take over the storefronts, because that weird... I was hoping Amazon was going
to
do it.
Yeah, that'd be cool to see Amazon stores. But we already have Amazon stores. They're called Best Buy.
Exactly. But I think the idea was the Amazon stores are just going to be like showrooms, which is... I don't think that's even economically viable. Why? You know what I mean?
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah. I remember me and Evie were at Best Buy a couple years ago, and she was wanting to buy a tablet, and the sales guy was like, you know, showing her tablets and everything. And at the time, I had my phone out, and I was looking up the tablet, and I showed her the price on Amazon and convinced her not to buy, like right in front of the employee, and he just kind of looked at me.
You remember the controversy when Amazon's released the app for the first time right around Black Friday, like 3 years ago? That you could scan any barcode and see what the price was on Amazon and compare.
Oh, I didn't even know you could do that.
Yeah, people were doing it on Black Friday, and like that was a big news story. Like,
I have
retail merchants are going to sue.
I have the Amazon app. I didn't know they had a barcode scanner in it.
I think it's called Amazon Price Check, to be honest. I think I have it.
Wow.
I've never used it, but...
So I'm looking at Google Maps, and I just typed in Radio Shack, and... It looks like one of those Verizon coverage maps. Like, there's so many red dots.
Jesus.
Like this is pretty huge that they're leaving.
And there were so many more before this.
Yeah, it's gonna suck.
Yeah, really.
Like, just with my show stuff, I'm constantly going there to buy audio cables, and there's nowhere else to buy audio cables here. I'm gonna have to drive,
mm-hmm.
Like 45 minutes away to Fry's.
Yep.
And not I don't think Fry's is that big, is it? Like, they don't... No, most people don't have Fry's.
No, we don't have fries on the East Coast, no.
Oh, like none?
No. Mm-mm. I know of them, but we don't have them.
Wow.
Yeah. I mean, I'm looking right now at my mix, and I got two adapters I bought at Radio Shack in it. Because, you know, you can just go there. It's, like, right down the street from here. They're open Sundays. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you can just...
Yeah, and I go there. I, like, you know, they have a tiny electronics components section these days. But I go there to buy, like, LEDs and switches and stuff. Mm-hmm. I'm always, like, making bombs and things. Like, no, seriously, I've like, you know, just solder. Like, where else am I going to buy solder?
Yeah, now you got to wait 3 days or whatever to buy it online.
Yeah, I guess I can just buy things online. But
it, yeah, I'm thinking about going to Radio Shack, just buying a bunch of some good solder and have it on hand. I got some already, but I never solder.
Maybe Walmart will set up their own little Radio Shacks. You know, like just a little island thing in the middle of the store of components or something.
Apparently all that needs the cabinet like Radio Shack has now. Or they reduce it to that sliding cabinet thing.
Yeah.
Walmart's wondered how they kept it organized. I was like, why isn't this thing all... They always had it organized, though. You know what I mean? Like, nah,
mine too.
You know? Yeah. I always wondered that.
Yep. Walmart's going to buy all their drawers. Hey, we should call Radio Shack as Walmart and say, hey, you think we could buy that drawer full of components and put it in our store? Oh, anyway, like, pick a state.
A state, Radio Shack. I'm thinking Texas Instruments, Texas.
Okay. That's their base, right? Dallas?
Yeah, actually, yeah.
Like, somehow I knew that last night. Probably, you know, I've been a Radio Shack customer for my entire life. Like, 5 years old on, probably. Mm-hmm. And I think they always wrote Dallas, Texas on all their stuff back
Fort
then.
Worth, actually, according Fort to Worth? Computer.
Okay. Yep. I'm a stupid. It's just practically the same city. Okay, so...
It's only the biggest state, second biggest in the world, in the country.
You want to take one?
Yeah.
Can you hear?
Yep, I hear a phone ring.
Woohoo!
Yeah!
This is Raisha.
Yes, hello, I'm calling from the Walmart.
Uh-huh.
We were wondering, since you guys are going to be closing up, can we purchase your drawer that has all the different components in it?
I'm not sure on that one.
Is there someone that speaks
right now,
English that could tell me?
Not here.
Is there someone that speaks English that could tell me?
Minutes.
Hello?
Yeah.
Are you listening?
I'm sorry?
Is there someone that speaks English that could tell me?
I'm telling you the store manager is not here right now. You want to know?
I can't understand your accent. Is there an English speaker that could tell me this? Okay.
Yeah, What the fuck's a man of here?
Man of here. It's still man of here, not here.
Hey, do you remember, like,
That was I burned that one quickly.
We got plenty to choose from.
I know. What's up?
But do you remember, like, back in the day, they like, Radio Shack, they always had just nerds working there?
Yeah, like people that actually knew shit.
Yeah, just weirdos. And like, now we've got females.
I was about to say women because my dad said that, dude. He went to Radio Shack looking for a needle for a record player. And he's like, there's a woman here. She ain't gonna know. I remember that. She ain't gonna know.
I went to Radio Shack this past summer. A friend of mine needed a certain type of battery. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it was a certain model number of a battery. And I went in there like, hey, I just need to get a battery. And he's all eager to help me. And he looked over he walked over to the batteries, you know, a weird calculator battery type thing. And he's like, no, we don't have that one. I'm like, are you sure? And he's like, yeah, I'm sure. I don't see this battery number on any of these packages. And, you know, you have to turn over the battery and look, see which one each one supports. And he just didn't know that. Like, the simplest thing ever. You just turn over the package and find your battery. But he swore to me they didn't have it. So I'm like, okay, well, I'm going to look myself anyway. And then I showed him. 2 minutes later. It took me 2 minutes.
You found it.
God damn it.
Laziness.
When I was a kid.
Back in my day. Yeah, the first mixer I had for my show, my wife bought it from Radio Shack online. And then I realized it didn't come with a power adapter. It just had like a 9-volt battery in it. Or you could buy the power adapter at Radio Shack. Like, fuck. So I ran out to Radio Shack, and it was a woman, and the woman swore up and down, yes, this is the adapter, I'm telling you, it's right here, look, it fits in it, she put it in and it fit in it and everything, and the model,
who cares and about wattages and volts and shit, yeah. It fits.
Yeah, well, sure enough, it didn't work, and I went back, and she was giving me, she's throwing me attitude, and then I was like, all right, so it's like, oh, you know, I surely didn't do that, she was telling, like, she didn't act like she didn't remember. So she grabbed another one, and I asked her to plug it in and turn it on the model. She gave me at it. She was like rolling her eyes, like, oh, fine. I'll take it out of the package and plug it in and show you.
Nerve of you.
Oh, my God. Yeah. The nerve of me to not want to come again. Third time. Second.
I'm going to talk to this one. I'm just going to laugh at him.
My hands are numb.
You're slowly dying. But come on, just you know, got to do at least an hour show, please. Wait till then.
This is Jerry. How may I help you?
Hi, this is Roy from the Walmart.
Uh-huh.
In nearby, and I just wanted to just say, like, haha, you know, you're going out of business, and we're not. We're pretty much a superpower at this point.
Okay.
Yep.
Well, thanks for calling, Roy.
And are you looking for a job? What are you going to be doing after you lose your job? This is going great so far. I was going to tell him no.
We could call from unemployment. That Radio Shack Corporate wants to schedule meetings.
Should we? Do you want
to
move
on? Go over your unemployment benefits? Can we come and do that later?
Yeah, let's tell them they get some sort of retirement plan.
Yes.
What do you call that? I don't know. The thing that they don't do anymore because old people live too long.
401k?
Maybe.
Or just pensions?
Pensions, maybe? That's the word.
Yeah. A Radio Shack pension, really?
You want to ask someone about that, or?
Yeah.
Okay. Severance.
Severance, yes.
Oh, my God. Tell them they get paid in batteries. It's from the chat room.
They can take whatever they want.
Radio Shack off Little Road. This is Sam. How can I help you?
Yes, hi, Sam.
Yeah.
Hi, Sam. I'm calling from the corporate office, Human Resources, regarding severance package information.
Okay.
Were you available to go over the benefits real quick on the phone?
I'm actually in the middle of eating, but yeah, eating. Sure.
Okay. All right. Did you get your date yet? Closure date?
No.
Okay, that'll be coming down the wire soon. Actually, okay. According to this, it is on Thursday. Yeah, Thursday will be the last day. So we need to take care of this quickly. Did you have any questions about the severance package, unemployment benefits, anything like that I could answer for you?
No, actually.
No? Did you have any plans? Did you file for unemployment already?
No.
You're in the state. You're able to file now,
right?
To have it ready, and they do withhold the first week, so you probably want to take care of that as soon as you can. You do that online too,
right? Yeah. Okay. My dad has been helping me with that mostly, but he's in New York right now, so he really can't help me with it. So.
Okay, well, I'll give you the information. The severance package, you're entitled to $300. It's going to be a $300 check. Taxes will not be taken out of it. So you will either want to, you know, set some aside, or you'll pay that on next year's taxes. It won't be much. It might be a few, less than $50 probably.
Right.
Okay. You're entitled to, I see here... Let me see, $326 in merchandise. You can take, on the list of merchandise, you can take our batteries, components, wires, cables, connectors, and that's it. Up to $326 retail before any closeout. Discount is applied to that.
Okay.
Did you have anything in mind you wanted to take? I can just kind of log that right now, so we have an idea for what will turn it, what's going to be left in inventory?
Probably just a couple of the 48 packs of batteries.
All right, couple 48 packs. All right. Did you want any cell phone accessories? You can take those too. I'm sorry, I missed that. Chargers,
one of
USB
the Note
cables.
Four Otter boxes. Thinking about grabbing one. Yeah, I'll probably grab one of those.
Okay, you can grab those now if you want today. I'll just put you down. So one Otter box for which phone model? iPhone 6
Note
or?
Note 4.
Hmm.
The Note 4.
Note 4. Oh, that's a good phone.
Yeah, it is.
I've got the Note Edge myself. Okay.
One of my coworkers has it.
Oh, yeah, who cares? Yeah, so I got you down for, you're going to take two 48 battery packs and the Note 4 OtterBox case. Excellent. Okay, all right. Well, I'll be sending you, we have your information here. We're going to be sending you in the mail, the severance package, full information. But definitely take care of that unemployment stuff. And okay. Like I said, maybe spread, is there anyone else there I should talk to that's there right now? We're closing Thursday, like I said. This location closes Thursday. Last day of operations and a business.
Have you
Thursday.
Spoken to Ed?
No. You're the first person at this location I talked to.
Oh, Ed, do you want to talk to... who are you guys again?
Human Resources, Corporate Office. I'll put Roy on the line for this
H&R
one. Because I actually have to eat myself.
You don't want to talk to H&R? Okay. He said no. But the other coworker just walked into Austin. He might want to talk to you.
Okay.
No. H&R. Corporate? Yeah.
HR. Corporate.
Yeah.
Fort Worth, Texas?
Okay, never mind. He does want to talk to you.
Why doesn't he want to talk to me?
No, he does.
Oh, he does. Okay. I'll put Roy on because I have to take my break. Roy, are you there?
Oh, okay.
Oh, this is Roy. Yeah, sure.
Yeah. All right. I'll be... Thanks.
Take a shit.
Hello?
Hello. Who am I speaking with?
Speaking with Ed Kalerchian. Who am I speaking with?
Oh, hey, Ed. This is Roy from the corporate office. I'm in the human resources department. How are you doing?
I'm okay.
Oh, that's good. And you've been notified. Have they sent you papers yet about your store closing this coming Thursday?
As far as I knew, I wasn't on the store closing list.
Oh, no. Yeah, it's closing in 2 days. They should have sent you something last week.
8196?
Yeah. On Thursday, you'll be working a full day on Thursday, and then after that, it's closing down permanently.
Okay.
We were just talking to the other employee there about his severance package. And, have you filed for unemployment yet?
No, sir. I was told this was an ongoing store.
Oh, no.
Recently as yesterday.
Oh, no. They were wrong. No. Who told you that yesterday?
My DM.
Oh, yeah. He must not know either. That's weird. I don't know. Maybe the paperwork got lost in the mail. But yeah, you're going to be... You just have 3 days total left there. And then at the end of closing day on Thursday, your store will be closed down. And you can go ahead and start marking things down today if you'd like. You haven't gotten the package that shows you how much to mark everything down?
No.
Okay, we can send that over the fax.
Okay. Roy, what's your last name? I'm sorry.
Gerbel. And I was going to let you know that, as part of the severance package, you get to take as many batteries as you want from the store.
Okay.
You can have pretty much anything. C cells... D cells, lantern batteries, calculator batteries,
All right.
Watch batteries.
All right, Roy, I need to call my DM.
Double A batteries.
Okay, I'm going to call my DM, Roy.
Okay. Triple A batteries.
Car batteries.
Thank you.
Car.
He's like, I don't know.
He said car batteries.
Yeah, can you imagine that car batteries? Why not? It's Radio Shack. He sounded like an older... I think he's been in the system for a while. He's one of the few, I think.
Can you imagine how happy he's going to be after he talks to the DM? Like he right yeah. now he's his world is just crushed. He thinks he lost his job.
Well, when he answers, like, yeah, you know, I'm all right. Like, it's like, yeah, we're all going through a tough time right now. So what? He said, as of yesterday, he's staying open.
Maybe the DM will believe it.
Oh, shit.
They'll just close it down.
Yeah. Knowing Radio Shack, they probably haven't really communicated well with any of them. Or most of them, at least. That's hilarious.
Hey, you know what would be great? And this probably won't work because it's Radio Shack. But it would be really great to call in and do the customer survey.
Good luck with it.
Get them to do the shopping spree.
We'll have to hold for like a day.
Yeah. I don't know. Maybe if we called one that's in... No, never mind. I was going to say one.
Hey, why don't we do an employee survey? Closing up. You know what I mean? An employee survey.
I want to call some of these... Oh, by the way, the number we called that Radio Shack from is yeah. from another Radio Shack.
Nice.
Because I have the caller ID set already for these first batch of customer numbers.
Awesome.
But yeah, yesterday, so I called up several Radio Shacks and got a bunch of return information. And people return things to Radio Shacks such as digital audio to analog, adapters, coax cable, battery exchange. All this stuff is so Radio Shack.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, an AT&T Trimline phone.
And Trimline?
Yeah, he returned an AT&T Trimline phone and purchased an RF modulator and an RCA cable.
Why not?
That sounds, I don't know, that sounds like something I would do in the late 80s or something.
I know, like a Trimline phone, dude. that's like the thin one with the caller ID on the handle or whatever. Like
I don't know. Yeah. Stereo patch cables. Where's everyone going to get all this stuff?
I know.
Someone's going to have to pick up
all this. Someone will fill the void.
Yeah, it's probably going to be Walmart.
Yeah, I'm thinking Best Buy.
Well, Best Buy is supposed to be kind of in trouble, too. I've been reading, you know, consumers have been reporting for years that Best Buy is not doing well.
They're not doing well. They're not there yet, though.
Yeah.
I think JCPenney and Sears/Kmart will go before Best Buy.
Oh, Sears is gone, isn't it? Like all of them?
They
closed down the one in my town, I guess. Maybe.
They closed down a lot, and a lot of their two-story ones, they converted to one-story.
Oh.
Yeah.
And oh, that's cool. I thought Sears was just gone.
But yeah, they have closed a lot of them, too, though.
Can't remember if our Kmart's still here or not.
Who knows? I know mine's here because it's next. I go there instead of Walmart because it's so closer and... So much closer and less people in there. That's the reason I go in there.
I've been in my local Kmart maybe three times since I've lived here in the past 8 years. And I've never been in there when there's been more customers than employees.
Yeah.
Like it's just us and nobody else.
Yeah.
And like tons of employees.
Yeah, it's trippy.
But yeah, can we call some of these customers?
Sure, man.
And, like this first lady, her name's Rose. She returned a digital audio to analog adapter.
What does she know?
Yeah. It's because she couldn't fit it in her toaster.
I can't fit it.
This doesn't work in my kitchen.
It doesn't go on my iPhone.
I wonder how many of my listeners believe that I'm really like that toward women.
I know. Yeah.
Because I am.
Mm-mm. No, you're not, dude.
So, Rose Lester is her name.
Rose Molester.
Say that.
No, you do the first one. I like the second one.
All right. Oh, man. Hello. Hello, is this Rose Molester? I'm calling for Rose Molester. This is Roy from Radio Shack.
Lester?
Yeah, Rose Molester is what we have here on the receipt.
Lester.
Yeah, no, it's Molester.
L-E-S-T-E-R.
M-O-L-E-S-T-E-R.
No, L-E-S-T-E-R. What's going on?
Oh, hey, well, you returned this digital audio to analog adapter.
Yeah.
But you didn't put a reason on it. Like, why'd you return it?
I told the girl that I got it for my auto... Why does it matter?
Hey, don't be a smartass. No, we need it for our records, and you didn't tell the girl anything.
Yes, I did. I told her that I got a sound bar, and that the reason why I returned it is because it wasn't going to work. And did you just tell me I was being a smart ass? What's your name?
Yeah, well, you're getting an attitude.
What's your
with
name?
Me. I already told you my
name.
Remember? My name's Roy.
No. Roy, okay, well, I'm going to file a complaint because you shouldn't even call someone talking.
Well, so
about
what?
That.
You know we're going out of business. Who are you going to complain to? We're going out of business no matter
care
what.
I don't care about you guys going out of business. You just called me talking shit.
Hey, fuck you, lady. Like, who do you think you're going to...
Yeah,
do you really
you.
Think...
You're mad because the adapter didn't work for my fucking thing and it was $40 and I took it back.
You just don't know how to use an adapter.
It didn't work, nigga. I use something else, boy. Don't talk to me disrespectfully. I'll come up there and smack you right now.
You don't even know how to use an adapter because you're...
What the fuck you're talking about?
You're a woman.
It doesn't work, you dumb bitch. I tried to work it. It didn't work, you faggot.
You just don't know how to use it.
Talking shit, you'll get beat the fuck up, you cracker.
Just go back to the kitchen.
Awesome. She calls you nigga.
And cracker.
Oh,
no, wait,
shit,
she called me cracker.
That's awesome. She called you a wigger.
Okay, so I think my manager needs to call her back.
That's awesome. All right, put me on.
Bruh, don't blow my phone up, bruh. I'll call the police.
Excuse me,
and say,
ma'am, I'm the manager here.
Me,
is there
a, I will make a harassment on you, bruh. Don't
wait
call
a minute.
My phone.
I'm did he speak rudely to you? I'm sorry.
Yeah, he did. He really spoke hella rude to me, talking about I'm being a smart ass. I don't understand what you guys got going on there, but I returned it last night, and I talked to some little white bitch. I don't know her name, some fat
white bitch.
Now my temper is way off. I should come up there and really just go off and call the police because that's way out of line, bruh. Like, that's really foul. That's no way a customer service person should ever represent themselves. How he's representing your company, whether you guys are quit, there's nothing in your company or nothing, that's disrespectful, bruh. And I don't care. I want your guys' district manager, all that. He, I don't know what the fuck he got going on. That's not right, bro.
All right, listen, you're acting like a gorilla. You're banned from the store. Don't you fucking come here. If you're going to talk like
that
to me.
I didn't ever come to that store. I haven't came. I came there to return it only for one reason, because it didn't work for my soundbar. I told her that it didn't work. I said I didn't understand how it worked. It didn't work. I bought two fucking different things.
Calm down. Calm down. Calm down.
No.
Yes.
No.
Calm down.
Why are you calling my phone?
Because I just went. I was trying to. He was rude to you and I just let him go. I kicked him out of the store. He's not allowed back here for talking
about
that.
Like,
I'm sorry.
Very upset because of how he just came at me. Like, that was really disrespectful.
Well, I'm sorry, honey. Honey, baby. I'm sorry, honey, baby. Okay? I'm going to take care of it, okay? All right.
Okay, and I'm not trying to disrespect you. I'm just saying that is just, that was really rude that he called my phone and then told me I was being
a
smart ass.
I know.
I was being a smart ass, and I was just asking why are you guys calling, because it's kind of weird,
sorry.
You know? I've never
I'm
had
sorry.
No one call me. Because I returned something to a store that didn't work for what I bought it for.
It's okay,
it didn't work.
Honey. It's okay.
So that's why I returned it. If you guys want to know why I returned it, it was $40 and I wanted my money back. It didn't work for the reason why I bought it. And I got another way for it to work, so I used another way. And I returned it. To, it might have been to a different store because I did buy it on 72nd, but I returned it. I have the receipt. It's not like there's nothing missing. I've never heard that before. Why are you calling me, asking me why I returned it if there's nothing wrong with the box? And then he called me and cursed at me. That's not customer service. That's really disrespectful, you know, and that makes me want to.
He told me you called him a cracker and the N-word.
Actually, he called me after he called me a bitch and cussed me out, and my dude was sitting right here and listened. He can vouch for me. I swear to you that he just said I asked him, he said, "Is this Rose a molester?" And I said, "My last name's Lester." And he was like, "Well, it says molester." I said, "Well, it's L E S T."
It does say that here. Whoever took your return did it, they had that you spelled it M O L E S T E R.
L E S T E R. I told her Lester. I don't know if
she's your middle name Mo.
What
is your middle name? Mo? M-O?
No, my name is Rose Lester. No, my middle name starts with an E. It has nothing to do with no M. So
okay,
My signature is R-L, scribble, scribble, scribble. It has nothing with an M. But all I have to say is that he called my phone and then said I was being a smartass because I was telling him that my name was a Lester. And it's not molester or whatever the hell he was saying. And then he got mad at me when I said, "Well, what is the reason why you're calling?" He said, "Well, I wanted to know why you returned it." I said, "Well, I returned it because it didn't work for the reason why I bought it." And he said, "Oh, you don't have to be a fucking smartass."
And that's disrespectful. And after that, that's when I got upset.
Can you shut up? Shut up, please. I'm looking at the camera.
Did you just tell me to shut up?
I said please. I'm looking at the camera.
You told me to shut up.
I'm looking at the camera footage when you came in. You're a hot little thing. You look nice.
Thanks, but you just told me to shut up. That was kind of rude.
I said shut up, please. I'm sorry. I said please.
I mean, it's called be quiet. I mean, would you want someone to talk to you like that? I'm just saying, or can I talk, or, you know, you're not understanding. I still don't even understand why you guys are calling me. You're calling me to tell me I'm hot.
No, because we tested the component and it works just fine. We thought it was because you're a woman.
It's not because of the component. It was because my TV is, I don't know what kind of TV I have. I bought it from the pawn shop and it didn't work with the component.
You fenced it? You bought it from someone who had stolen it and you gave them money and they fenced it? Is that what
No. I bought it from the pawn shop, my TV.
You fenced it.
How is that?
Like someone stole it and then you bought it for less money, right?
No one stole anything. What are you talking about?
That happens a lot in the urban community, the African American community. I know it's cool. I'm down. That's how I bought my.
Did you just? Are you insulting me and calling me African? What does African American got anything to do with? Because that don't make no. You guys are out of pocket. Like that don't have nothing. That don't have nothing to do with anything. I don't understand that.
Well, I know because in your communities, you guys like.
I'm saying what I said is that I bought a fucking. What I said is I bought a TV from the pawn shop. I don't know if it's stolen. I don't know what the fuck's wrong with it. I bought a TV from the pawn shop and I bought the Xbox from Walmart and I decided I wanted to buy a soundbar. I bought me a motherfucking soundbar and it didn't work because I didn't have the right plugs. I called your store. They told me I need the adapter. I live by 72nd, so I took my ass to 72nd Radio Shack and bought the adapter. When I bought the adapter, it did not work. So I used the auxiliary cord in my headphone cord in the back of my TV, and it worked. And I took back the $40 merchandise because I wanted my motherfucking money back. That didn't work. And I don't understand why you guys are even calling me because you guys got the receipt. It doesn't matter if it works or not. Don't call my phone and you guys got the receipt. I want my... What is that? What the fuck? And then you guys got somebody calling me disrespecting me, and then you're telling me you're hot. I don't understand. You guys are so unprofessional. That's exactly why you guys are going out of business, bro.
Be honest with me. Did you actually return it because you're poor? Is that... Yeah, that's... I can put that down as the reason. That's okay. Just tell me. Be honest.
Bitch, I'm probably sitting on more money than you got, boy. You better watch your mouth, nigga. Yeah, I got money. I'm not poor. You better watch your mouth. I could come back and buy that adapter, four or five of them adapters right now. It's nothing. I don't know.
And you won't know how to use them because you're stupid.
I don't care. You're petty. Who are you?
Fuck you.
You have no.
She hung up.
Oh shit. I kept getting her back into it with little comments all over.
I thought she was saying she bought the analog adapter thing from the pawn shop and then returned that to Radio Shack.
Yeah. Oh, she did not like the stolen TV thing. What do you mean? You told me I'm hot? What kind of shit's that?
Well, that was just like the first number.
That's awesome.
We just have like 30 to go now. She's just going to be pissed all day now. Mm. iPhone 5 case exchange. Who wants to start? Me or you?
You do.
Okay. I don't know what to say about. Oh. I'm gonna skip this one. I'm gonna do the one where this lady, she returned a pack of DVD-Rs, recordable DVDs.
You can tell they're recorded on already.
Yeah.
They have porn on.
Yes. Oh, I hope she's home. I can buy 5 or 6 adapters. It'd be nothing to me. Why'd she return it then? She has so much money.
Hey, hello.
Hi, is Kim available?
This is Kim.
Oh, that's a girl's name, though.
Oh, well.
Oh, well, hey, I'm calling from the Radio Shack. You returned some DVDs, recordable DVDs here?
Yeah.
And there's a small problem.
What's the problem?
Well, we have to look at the things before we put them back on the shelf. So we put the DVDs in the computer, and they're all filled with pornography.
Come on, man. I just bought those things the day before.
Right, and
so with pornography.
You must have spent all night writing all this porn to them.
But you can't do that.
What's that now?
What'd you do? Did you just want to get rid of your porn and get free writable DVDs? Is that the scam here?
My God, brother, I never went in that box.
Huh?
I never went in that box.
I don't believe you, because we opened up the box and we put the discs in.
I don't even have any. I got one porn. I got one porn disc.
Which one is it?
Well, I've only watched it one time. I don't even remember. I don't even watch porn.
What kind of, is it like girl on girl, man on girl?
I haven't the faintest. I can't even remember.
Huh.
It's been so long since I even looked at the one I've got.
Gay porn?
Oh, God. Are you kidding?
Well, I don't know.
Jesus Christ, man. I'm a Vietnam veteran. There ain't no gay in my life.
There's quite a bit of gay porn on these DVDs of yours that you gave us.
Jesus.
What?
Well, brother, I tell you what. They were in that box and somebody put some kind of weird shit out.
Do you hear it? I'm playing it right now. It's like a guy named Bill.
I'm just saying, I didn't do a damn thing like that.
I've got it playing like on.
Fucking not.
I've got it playing on all
Why
the TVs.
Would I do something like that? There's fucking got to be a law against that.
I've got it playing on all the TVs in the store right now, and it's like a guy named Bill.
Oh, God. Well, yeah, I bet you're enjoying that then, huh?
Yeah. Well, there's nobody else in the store, so. But yeah, like. You can't do this. You can't do this to us because we can't.
I didn't do that. I swear to God, I did not do that, my friend.
We can't erase these discs.
Why would I do something like that? If I had more than one porn, I'm sure I would have watched another one besides the one I've got.
These aren't rewritable discs.
Like I said, I've only used that one I've got one time.
Mm-hmm. Why'd you only watch it once?
I'm 66 years old, bro. I can't even get it up anymore.
Really?
Hardly.
That must suck.
Yeah.
Well, when's the last time you watched that one porn video?
Oh, God, gotta have been, maybe 8 months ago, maybe.
Oh, really? Did you, I don't know, did you enjoy it? Like, how long did you watch it for?
You made me miss my putt, bro.
Oh, did I?
I'm playing golf, yeah.
Yeah, is that what you call it, playing golf?
Oh, yeah, that's all I can do anymore.
I'm glad you think this is funny, but, you know, we're pretty much screwed out of this money.
It's hilarious to me. It's hilarious to me because you got a bunch of free porn, apparently.
Yeah, well.
You know what I mean?
We don't need free porn because, you know, there are websites. It's all free now. Like, who watches porn on DVDs anyway? That's stupid.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I got the computer on my phone. I've never even went to any site like that. I wouldn't want it on my phone.
Oh, go to pornhub.com. That works good on mobile phones.
So what do you want me to do? Come back down and get all those porn?
Yeah.
And give you $5.99?
I think you should. I think that's the right thing to do.
I might as well.
I know it's not a lot of money, but I don't know why you feel like you need to scam us out of $6.
Well, I just told you, I don't lie, man. I'm a disabled Vietnam veteran, brother, and I take care of my shit.
It seems like you use that as
Parkland. I got race stock cars, man. I play golf. You know, I have a lot of fun. I don't even fucking think about women or anything else for that matter.
It seems like you use the Vietnam vet thing as just, you know, to your excuse for everything. Like, I can do what I want because I'm a Vietnam vet.
I'm 100% disabled, brother.
Not 100%. You made it
I'm
to the store.
I'm not 5% disabled. I'm not just disabled. They give me money every month because of my disability.
But that doesn't give you the right to steal DVDs from us.
I didn't steal them.
It's like you returned.
But I told you I would come down and take them out of your store for $5.99. It probably cost me $20 to buy one, wouldn't it?
What, to buy a porn DVD?
Yeah.
No, they're free on the internet. Everything's free on the internet.
Well, you got to have a way to fucking get them, though, don't you?
Yeah, an internet connection, stupid.
Well, I got it on my phone. That's all I got. Can't do a DVD with a fucking phone.
I think you're full of shit. I don't think you're coming.
Oh, now you can kiss my ass then, brother.
I don't think you're going to show up here and... Oh, okay, he's gone.
Oh, he finally got upset. Jeez, my... If he's disabled, why is he playing golf?
Yeah, that's not 100% disabled. How's
he's scamming.
Swinging the golf club if it's 100% disabled.
He shouldn't be able to even leave his house. I know these rules.
Like, unless he's like Stephen Hawking, he's not 100% disabled. He's like an insurance scammer.
Yeah, seriously. I race stock cars. What did he say?
Yeah, he does everything. He's more active than me.
Yeah. Disabled my ass.
So you want batteries exchange, or do you want... audio adapters, coaxial batteries. Cable.
Batteries.
All right. Okay. Batteries is a David Watt. That's a Radio Shack customer name, David Watt.
That's awesome. Like, no, what, really? What is your last name?
You probably thought that was really clever, putting your last name as Watt. So David is the name.
Hello?
Yeah, is that David Twat? David Twat?
Who's this?
This is Bill. I'm calling from Radio Shack. You had a return?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. We tested these batteries. There's nothing wrong with them. A, B, they are empty. They have no power left in them. Looks like you used them.
No, I brought batteries back in a package. I never took them out.
We can see on the side where you resealed them with glue and scotch tape.
But
like you cut it with a penknife, it looks like, to make it nice and sharp. But
No, I brought them back within a 15-minute period of time, so I don't know what you're talking about.
Nope. He goes,
If we keep this up, Radio Shack's going to be going out of business because we're going to lose all their customers.
Yep. Hello?
No. You need to come back and get your batteries.
I don't know what you're talking about, bud, but...
Well, I just declined your return. It's not going to make it. You're not going to get your money back, sir. Huh? I just put a...
What?
I just put a decline on your return.
Already returned it. I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, but you're not going to be able to get the funds. Like, the money you got back, you're not getting it.
Oh, okay.
Like, I declined it, all so... Right. You might as well come here and get your fucking batteries.
Yeah, okay. All right, bud.
Fuck you. Baby food.
Baby food, what?
I don't know. I was hoping you got a cash return. I was going to tell him the cash was going to be declined. I've always wanted to have a prank where I could say, no, your cash was declined. I've never been able to use that yet.
We could say like it's some sort of remote thing where it makes the cash turn black or something.
Yeah. Well, I'm just hoping to do like a pizza customer one day and they're like, I paid cash. And we're like, no, your cash bounced. Like, what? It declined. There weren't enough funds.
That one was too short. I think you should take this next one for coaxial cable.
Coaxial.
This guy's name is Steven Struck. Pretty good answer rate on these so far.
Yeah.
It's not like those gym customers.
That's awesome.
Or the bank customers I gave you.
We could have been doing these this whole time.
No one is available to take your call.
Yeah, we've got to do this a lot more. Like, when is Radio Shack disappearing forever?
I don't know, because that one guy was like, no, we're staying open. Yeah. I don't know. I don't know how that works. It usually takes at least a month, right? Because they liquidate and...
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Maybe we'll have to sales that aren't really sales, you know, like you go like 20% off. it's like on bullshit. I never find anything good on those fucking sales.
Oh, yeah.
It's going out of business. Because all the good shit, they sell it to other companies.
At Sears, I went to their going out of business sale, and I got a $20 hoodie. The tag said it was normally $60.
Mm-hmm. So, well, you know,
I feel okay about that one. It's probably a fake tag, though. It's probably originally $15. So I guess you're going to talk to Sherry Richardson.
Sure.
She returned audio adapters.
Sears has actually been more successful lately, according to this. Internet sales rising nearly 20%. Well, that means they're going to end up being like a catalog company like they used to be.
Hello?
Hi, yes. Is this Radio Shack customer? I'm calling from Radio Shack. You returned something?
Yes.
Okay. Sherry, right?
Yes.
Yeah, you returned a audio adapter?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, we have a few problems because you didn't put down a Y. And we tested the adapter and it works just fine. Are you trying to scam us or something?
No,
tell that kid to shut the fuck up.
Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah, can you tell the kid to shut the fuck up, please?
Who are you talking to?
Well, to you directly or the kid indirectly. Can you tell him to
shut
up?
Okay, I'm coming to the store right now. Are you in the store right now?
Yeah, I'm in the back. What are you going to do?
Okay, I want you to come out, okay?
And what? You want to kiss and hug?
No. Why are you being so rude?
I'm not into women that have kids already, sorry. I'm not going to be his or her dad.
I have a husband. Now, if you want a good beat down, I'm going to the police right now. That's what I'm going to do.
Thank no, the police you. Don't beat down white dead people. Dead. You got it wrong.
Excuse me.
Yeah?
In all fairness, that kid did need to shut the fuck up.
Seriously. Get control of your kids.
I'm going to be the manager.
Please.
Hello?
Hello, this is Thomas. I'm the manager here at the Radio Shack. And did you just talk to an employee of mine?
Yeah, he just cussed me out for no reason.
Oh, no, I was standing right here. He didn't say any cuss words.
Oh, he did.
No.
I'm coming down there right now.
No, listen.
Don't worry about it. I'm coming down
ma'am,
right now.
Don't bring that fucking baby here.
Shh. Hey, not again. Ma'am?
Oh, so you didn't hear that?
Well, now he's cursing because you started it.
I did not. He didn't even let me answer the question. He asked me what was wrong with the adapter. I returned the merchandise because we couldn't use it because we bought equipment and the equipment was returned.
Is it because you don't know how to use things that aren't in the kitchen because you're a woman?
Okay, I'm going to the Pierce County Police Department.
For what?
And we'll handle that.
You're going to tell them you got bad customer service?
Goodbye.
What do you think they're going to do?
Oh, my hamburger doesn't have onions, please.
Hello, police. An employee was rude to me. Arrest them immediately. Police are going to be like, yeah, you know they're going out of business. They're just blowing off steam, ma'am.
Yeah, and they're going to run her license and arrest her.
Yeah, exactly.
You got like 5 outstanding warrants here.
Hey, did you notice that the baby was quiet?
Yeah, he just showed up. Yeah.
She did something about it.
I don't want to be the baby's daddy.
Hey, you ever shoplift from Radio Shack?
Yes. I was younger.
Yeah. Just last week. I learned how to shoplift when I was 14. And I spent I went in the mid-80s. I'd go in there and just hang out on their Tandy computers. Just write programs and stuff. And they got so used to me, they would just leave. They go in the back room. They go outside and stuff. And I cleaned up that store. Just thousands of dollars. I got all these computer manuals for my computer. All this, big cartridges for my TRS-80. Tons and tons of electronic components. I kept stealing chips because I thought I was going to build a robot or something.
The days before cameras were prevalent, man.
Yeah, no cameras. That's just, that just wasn't. Even at Radio Shack, you'd think they'd have cameras, but nope.
Nope. They got those fake ones there.
The managers loved me for some reason. They was like, oh, hey, how you doing?
You ever see the fake web cameras they have, security cameras?
Oh, yeah, I worked in places that have those.
The fake ones?
Yeah, the convenience stores, it's just this big 3-prong plug that plugs into the wall and it just lights up a light.
Yeah.
It doesn't plug into anything else at all. Randall Thor says I was building a killer robot. Did you steal anything good though, from Radio Shack?
What did I steal? Headphones a few times.
Ah.
I wanted to steal a. No, I did. Yeah, I had and I used it for a long time. A realistic fucking mini cassette recorder.
Oh, nice.
And then a lot of the mini cassettes I did. I stole those too. Yeah. Not a lot. I had 3 or 4 packages of them over several years.
I mostly went for electronic components because those were easy. Those were always in those little aisle things on the back.
Yeah.
And they never had a good view of back there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Those mini cassettes, I used them for prank calls and shit.
I still have a mini cassette. Wait, maybe I don't. I don't know. I had it for years. I think I still have it, and I think it has prank calls of mine from high school. But I haven't had a mini cassette recorder in a long time. I think Neon sent me a mini cassette answering machine. I should try it in there. Listen to my old pranks.
Yeah, see if they work. Yeah. That's how I used to do it, because, you know, you could the mini cassette answer machines, and you could hit a record button and record the phone line and just dial out. Yeah. That was the way.
Yep, yep. And I had one of those line-in phone recorders that I would hook up to it.
Ah. Never got those until later.
Yeah, and tons of suction cup microphones to use on payphones and stuff.
That's what you used at Walmart, right?
Huh?
The suction cup ones? Is that what you used at Walmart?
It wasn't a suction cup, but it was the same principle, like a coil induction mic, and it just goes in your ear. But instead of suction cupping onto the phone, it's just sticking in your ear like one of those late 90s cell phone headset things.
Oh, I gotcha.
Which seemed inconspicuous like 5 years ago when I did that. I think it'd look kind of weird now. But I mean, I could put one in the other ear and just be like I'm listening to my iPhone.
Yeah, you got my iPhone.
Yeah, that's it. I think we're about done with this store. There was that lady that hung up on us. I'll try her again. Megan.
We could do the first lady again. See if she's cool down.
Or we could...
the last lady's probably packing up her baby now and going down this.
Yeah, we could call her back and just be like, hey, you know, we're just kidding around. We're losing our jobs this week. There's nothing you can do.
It's blowing off some steam.
What was her name? Sherry. Yeah, let's call the last. Hold on. Let me call back. Let me delete Kim. Okay, I'm going to call the first. I'm going to call Rose Molester. Hello, Mrs. Molester?
Who is this?
Oh, hi, this is Dave. I'm with the local, the Z100 radio station, with the local wacky morning show, Skippy and Dippy. And I just wanted to let you know, that wasn't really Radio Shack you were talking to before. That was our wacky morning DJs. I'm the producer here. And I just needed to get your permission for us to air that hilarious phone call to you on the air tomorrow morning. You know, is that okay with you? Because so our listeners can laugh at you, and how angry you got. Is that okay? Hello, Mrs. Molester. Hello.
My name is not Molester.
Oh, that's what it says here on the form.
What form?
Here at the radio station, Radio Shack. They share all of their customer data with us, and then we prank call their customers. It's for our wacky morning show.
How can you guys play that with all those curse words?
Oh, we bleep them out.
Yeah, oh, hell no.
And we edit everything in our favor, so you look extra dumb.
So I look extra dumb. You make me look extra dumb.
Yeah,
Do you hear what you sound like?
Creative editing. No, it's a radio station industry thing. Everyone does it. We have to stay competitive.
Really? What radio station is this?
Z100. 100.3. The Gerbil. 100.3, the Gerbil. The Skippy
and... The Gerbil?
Yeah, the Skippy and Dippy Morning Show.
The Skippy and Dippy Morning Show. Yeah. I don't think I've heard... Well, I don't really listen to the radio. The radio's whack.
We have billboards everywhere with the big gerbil on it in the morning
show. I think I've actually seen that towards Fife area.
They don't have billboards.
I'm looking you up because I kind of don't like your prank.
Oh, well, of course you don't like it. You're the butt of the joke. But they don't have billboards over by the pawn shop that you go to all the time?
I don't know. I don't pay attention to the billboards. I drive.
You seem a lot more calm now. Did you use some drugs or something?
Oh, nah. I'm still upset. It just doesn't make no sense how you think this is a joke.
Well, don't be upset. It was just a joke. It was funny.
It's not funny. What if I would have went up to Radio Shack and got myself into trouble because you guys' jokes are so funny.
Oh, that happens. That does happen sometimes, but they're used to it because they sell us their customer data so that we can prank them all. So they're used to people. You know, sometimes people just rush up there and start beating up employees before we're able to tell them it was a prank.
Oh,
like this
really?
Last lady we just called, she's on the way. I think she called the police.
Yeah.
But it's wacky, you know? It's all wacky. It's a wacky morning show, and it's all for the good of the show.
It's
sounds kind of wacky and sounds like a kind of like a little bit of bullshit.
Why do you think the radio is whack?
Because they play this, shit. I don't listen to no radio. Q93 plays the same shit over and over.
Yeah, that's what we do.
I don't want to listen to the top 10 songs. I'd rather listen to the top 10 songs I fucking like.
It's the top 40. It's the top 40, you 40, stupid bitch.
Or 40, 10. But it seems like 10. It seems like the same 10 song plays. I don't listen to the radio.
It's the top 40, you stupid bitch. You stupid bitch. Listen. God damn it. It's the top 40. It's not the top 10. You're exaggerating.
It doesn't matter. Are you bored? Are you bored with your life?
No. I'm the producer here. I get paid for this.
Oh, you get paid to talk shit.
Yeah, well, no. It's the Skippy and Dippy. They're the ones that called you before. I'm just the producer.
Roy, tell her. I mean, don't worry about it. Black people aren't in our demo.
That's true.
In our demographics. So
they all think that the radio's whack.
Yeah.
So whatever, lady, we're gonna play it whether you want us to or not. It's gonna happen.
I don't care. It's not my name, no way. So.
Rose. Have Molester. A nice one. Your name is Rose Molester. We have it on the form. It's not her name, no way, Carlito.
Yeah, you signed it RL Scribble.
She was a lot nicer that time. Like,
yeah,
she calmed down.
She smoked a bowl. Or, I guess, a blunt.
Yep. She thought it was hilarious. Do you want to talk to the Sherry again and tell her it was a prank?
Yeah, calm her down.
She's probably, hold on, I'm on the other line with the cops.
It's going to hear
Hello?
Her. Yeah, Sherry?
Hello?
Sherry?
I'm coming with the police. With the police.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Nope, I'm coming with the police. Thank you. I appreciate it.
I'm locking the door. Uh-oh.
She's not coming with the police.
Come on. What do you think? They're escorting her there right now, like two motorcycle cops.
All units, calling all cars.
We need an escort to the Radio Shack.
This is the last time this is going to happen.
We'll show them.
Let me try Megan Sweet one more time. She's not picking. She's the one that picked up and hung up on us.
You have reached the voicemail box of.
All right. Well, that's all for that store. No more. We only have 5 stores left now.
That was great for one store. We got a lot of answers.
Yep. We could call some more stores directly and try our.
Sure.
Try our. Hey, did you see the John Oliver goodbye thing for Radio Shack?
No, I've seen a lot of stuff, but no, is it a video?
Yeah, it's a video, but I think it'll work good as an audio commercial. So I'm gonna play this real quick.
Yeah.
Oh shit! I don't know if you're gonna be able to hear it though.
That's fine. I can. Well, if you want to take a break, because that way I can actually take care of something real quick, so I can stay on longer.
Okay, everyone, we're gonna take a quick break here, but we're gonna start out with this John Oliver video. It's like a goodbye to Radio Shack thing from the John Oliver show. And we'll play a couple songs.
I'll listen on my iPad, and I may not be back when you return, but I'll be back ASAP in a few minutes. Okay.
All right. All right.
Bye.
All right. So this is a kind of a goodbye PSA from Radio Shack. And this is the, here it goes.
For nearly a century, we at Radio Shack have proudly served America.
Radio Shack.
Providing you with the highest quality home electronics at the best prices. And now, sadly, it's time for us to say goodbye. And so we would like to offer this special farewell message to America. Go f*** yourselves. That's right. Take a 30-pack of batteries and shove them directly up your ass. Who sold your parents that remote control car you got for Christmas in 1993 that you love so damn much? Radio Shack, motherfuckers, that's who. And remember in 1989 when you needed a cable to plug your Nintendo into the TV? Who was there for you? That's right, Radio Shack again, assholes. And now look at you, laughing at our slow, painful death. Well, laugh while you still can, shitheads, because one day, you too will be obsolete.
One day, you two will be left behind in the wake of time's ceaseless onslaught. And when that day comes, know that we'll be standing over your goddamn grave laughing our asses off. So America, from all of us here at Radio Shack, goodbye and go to hell, you filthy animals.
News, sports, music, but mostly prank calls. You're listening to Prank Call Nation.
My mind's got a mind of its own. Sometimes I can't find it at home. It hides in the stove. Shit, talk about your brain being baked. My shit.
All right, I'm tired of this. Let's just do the show.
Yeah.
Yeah. Fuck shows. I mean, fuck
music.
Shut
the batteries up your ass.
That's right. So what'd you do?
Took a quick shower and got half dressed.
Oh, okay. All right.
Cause you got to shower before you go to the doctor. You can't be smelling bad.
Yeah.
And I have a female doctor and she's cute, so.
Yeah, got to shower. So I've got more. I've got my caller ID set up to the next store. If we want to call some more customers, or do you want to start with some more Radio Shack store calls?
Let's do a store.
Okay. Yeah, we haven't done those in a while.
Yeah.
Who's taking it?
You start. I like beans. Yeah.
Okay. I want to make some more people sad that they're going out of business forever.
Thank you for calling the Radio Shack. This is Catherine.
Hi, Catherine. Is this the Radio Shack manager?
Yes, it is.
Oh, okay, great. I'm calling from the corporate office, from the human resources department.
Okay.
And I just needed to let you know that your store's scheduled for closing, like right now, permanently. We're going to be closing your store today. Yep, that's the one. Yep. Is that a customer that just came in?
Yes, it is.
Oh, might be a good... Well, anyway, yeah, we're closing your store for the day, so you might want to tell them to go.
Just for today?
No, for permanently. Because, you know, Radio Shack, we filed for bankruptcy this past week.
Okay.
Could you tell that customer to leave? Because we can't sell anything more today.
All right, I will do.
Okay, and then come back to the phone, please, because we have to go through the close down procedure.
Okay, just a second.
Okay, thank you. Is she consoling someone? It's okay, customer.
I think it's a coworker.
All right. Yeah, so much.
All right. Sent her away.
I just woke up, man.
I think it is.
I'm
tired.
My
body's hurting. And it hurt, baby.
Like,
hurting.
Like,
I know.
Motherfucker.
Let me lock the door. All right, baby. I'll see you in a while.
All righty. Okay. So did you send that...
Let me lock the door.
Okay. Did you send that employee home?
Ain't nobody here with me.
Oh, I thought I heard another person, a guy talking there.
Yes, and he's going to go out the door.
Oh, okay. Was that another customer?
Yes.
Oh, wow. It's a busy day there today.
Yeah, we are the busiest store in town.
Huh. Well, not anymore, I guess.
I guess not. All right.
Do you know where the breakers are in the store?
I mean, I know how to turn the lights out.
Yeah, but do you usually use the breakers or do you use light switches?
We got, we go into the little silver box.
Oh, the silver box. You don't do the clap thing?
No, I don't got no clap things.
Oh, okay, yeah, that's what we've done with a lot of our stores in the West Coast.
It's really... Okay, so will we get our checks on Thursday?
Oh, yeah, you'll still get that. The district manager is going to be there doing all the liquidation stuff. But we need you to go to the breaker box and just turn off every single switch.
Okay, well, the only switches that are on is the lights in the store.
Yeah, but there's other things like computers and the cameras in the walls that watch the employees, all the hidden stuff and the...
Okay, see, I don't know how to do them. Cellular. I've never done those before.
Oh, yeah, you just turn off everything. Turn off all the switches. Do you have a cordless phone?
Okay, see, this is what I mean by when I say that.
Oh, the silver box. That's the fuse box, right? Like the breakers?
Yes.
Is there just one fuse box?
Yes.
And do you turn off everything?
Okay.
Or do you turn off everything, or do you just turn off a few switches?
Well, I usually only do the ones with the tape that's on those.
Oh, no. This time, instead of just the tape switches, we have to turn off every one of them one at a time. But you have to do them in order, like one, two, and can you say the number as you hit it? Just for confirmation.
Okay, and this is what I'm saying, because there's the main principle at the top of the box.
Oh, no, we'll turn the main one off last. We're going to start with number one.
Okay, and I'm on the left-hand side.
Yeah.
And it says, it has a, well, all of them, okay, this one has a 20 on the button, and it says 10KA.
Yeah.
120240V.
Okay. Yeah. Just start at the top left and go all the way down, and just say the numbers as you go down.
Oh shoot! Then you just cut me out too. I can't see now.
Well, just try and try and feel around.
Okay. Because you just put me in the dark.
Oh, that's terrible. Maybe do you have a cell phone light?
Okay. So now I can't see the numbers. So I'm just going straight down the line then.
Yeah, just forget.
And now I can't see a thing. Because the first switch turned out the light in the room where I'm at.
Well, I guess you can turn that switch on, back on, and that top one, just so you can see. We have infrared cameras, though, so we can see you. So that's all that matters.
Okay, so you can see me?
Yeah, with the infrared cameras in the walls.
Okay. So other than that, everything else is going off.
Okay. You're turning off all the switches?
Okay, this last one. It don't move. Oh. It has like a gold surrounding on it.
Do you have a hammer?
On the bottom.
Do you have a hammer?
I might have something.
Well, actually, it's okay. We can just leave that one. I think I know what that is.
Okay, I think I got like two or three of those.
Oh, they have like these things around them so you can't move them?
Correct. With screws in them.
Oh. You have a gun.
What kind of gun?
You know, just shoot those.
Oh, no.
Covers.
I don't do them. I don't do guns and knives.
All right. We'll just leave those.
All I got to do is fingernails and jewelry.
Do you have a glass of water? We could throw a glass of water on it and that would short it out.
Oh, well, shit, you ain't going to kill me in that little room.
But you have to turn off your light first.
Oh, well,
so you don't have a chance.
Okay, well, let me make sure my cages and stuff are locked all up.
And
doing good today.
Oh, really? Did they tell you about your severance package? You get to take all the batteries with you. You can take them home.
I don't want no damn batteries.
Well, you could sell those.
I ain't trying to sell no batteries. I can sell some phones. Can I have a couple of phones or something?
Okay, yeah, you can have phones instead of batteries.
Are you serious?
Yeah, why not? I mean, what the hell? It's a crazy day. Just...
I can have a phone?
Yeah. I mean, the cameras are off now anyway. You turned off the cameras, so I can't even see you. So it's...
Well, no, my cameras are still on.
Well, no, we'll keep it on the down low. Well, how are they on if you turned off all the power?
Because I haven't turned them all off the power yet. Well, let me turn the power off first.
Yes, yeah.
I guess I ain't got no job anyway, huh?
Yeah, fuck it. Fuck it.
Yeah, but I'm not a thief.
That's true, but I'm giving you permission.
Okay. Okay, everything else is going off then. I'm on the right-hand side now. Okay, I ran into another one of those screw ones, so I'm going to miss that one.
Oh, darn it.
There she goes.
All right, so listeners, if you don't know what happened, she was on a cordless that requires power, and she just lost power.
Oop.
And I was just asking in the IRC, should I tell her it's a prank or not? But I guess there's no option. She's not going to take a phone. I should have at least told her. I'm like, oh, you know, after you hang up with me, call your DM and just let him know.
I thought for sure when you said fuck it, she'd figure it out. But she's like, yeah, you got a point. Fuck it.
But I thought the part where I asked if she had a gun.
Yeah, that's like all I got is sticky nails and jewelry.
Did she say that?
Sticky nails and jewelry.
Oh, I didn't even catch that. That's hilarious.
Well, you think she'll turn it back on?
I don't know.
Because I think she's pretty much committed just to leave it all off and bug the fuck out.
She's excited now. Like, day off.
Yes, I get to go home.
Yeah, watch some Maury. Holy crap.
Judge Joe Brown.
I love that part at the beginning. He's like, oh, I'm in the dark.
Oh, Lord, you got me in the dark now.
Airhead says this is the Arblito show.
Arblito.
It's awesome.
Carby.
All right, I guess the next one's you.
Woo.
Hey, we should do more in that same town, so like she's not singled out.
Yeah,
They're like, well, all the stores got shut down. And they have...
At least the DM knows of someone fucking with her.
Yeah.
So wait, did she say she was going to take some phones?
She did. She did, but then she's like, oh, I'm not a thief. But then I told her I was giving them to her, so it's not a thief.
Yeah.
I don't know. I guess she's struggling with that decision right now. Okay. You want one?
Yeah. Well, she might be waiting for you to call back.
No,
she might have turned it back on.
Yeah, I guess she could go over to maybe they have like a wall phone, you know, with doesn't require power.
call her back. Let's see what's
going on. Okay.
Sure.
Or what are we going to say to her, though? Are we gonna...
I don't know. Just tell her. I feel bad if she takes phones or something.
LOL, yeah,
or
JK. Oh, it's busy.
Oh, shit. She's calling someone.
She's talking to the DM. Let's pretend that.
Yeah, she's all right.
She's not calling all her friends. Hey, everyone, free stuff.
I got free phone.
Come and get it. Okay, so here we go. This is for you. This is Radio Shack. This one's already closed down.
Hello? Yes, hi. Is this store a... No, this is... All right, you were just on the line with Roy? Yeah, you're closed. Yes. Oh. I just got a call maybe about 5 minutes ago. We are done. I am shutting down all the power in the store, and it is done. Oh, my goodness. Are you opening again for anything? Yeah. Or, like, forever closed? Forever closed. Well, I'm sorry. That's all right. I'm out of here. All right. Good luck. All right. No problem. Bye. Thank you. Bye. See you. Bye-bye.
Oops, sorry, I dialed the wrong number.
Well, at least we got some closure on that, though.
I thought you were going to set things right, but nope.
I should have, but I was like, it's just, damn it. Just like, I'm out of here.
I love when we got to hear the customer leave, and then you heard the ding dong.
Yeah.
Okay, all right. So here, I'm calling the other one for real for you.
Oh my god, what's going on? Someone's gonna flip their shit when they find out. You what?
We gotta call every store in the city now.
Radio Shack speaking, how may I help you?
This is number...
Are you calling from this store?
Well, I'm calling from the corporate office. I'm looking for... This should be in the mall?
Yes, in the mall.
Okay. Yeah, okay, I'm calling from the corporate office. You are listed for closure today.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So, actually, as soon as possible, do you have any customers inside the store right now?
Yes.
Could you kindly let them know we can't do any more purchases? Actually, the POS system should be deactivated in a few seconds if it's not already.
Okay.
Could you first let them know to head out, lock the door, and come back so we can go through the closing procedures, please? The first step?
Okay, just one moment.
Thank you, dear.
Yeah. But what's your name?
My name is Cross. Cross, I'm in Fort Worth, Corporate Human Resources. I'm on the team that's handling the bankruptcy sale to the lenders.
So we do it over the phone, are you sure?
The first step is over the phone, and then you'll have a van from corporate should be showing up. They're at the university store right now, 4131 University, and they'll be headed over to you next.
Okay. Okay, just one moment.
Okay. I got about 10 minutes before I got to go. It sucks. It's actually getting good there.
Okay.
You keep going on though, right? You?
Yeah, I'll do. I'll do a little while longer.
Yes, I'll keep listening. Maybe they're throwing stuff like when we do this at 7-11.
Did she mute us? It didn't sound like she muted us.
I don't know. Maybe she was far away. We should have had that other lady put a big sign to say out of business.
So when you said that thing about the van, I was thinking we should get a van and write Radio Shack on the side of it with window paints and like show up and go to a Radio Shack, have the employees load it up.
Yeah, just have an Uber van show up.
Yeah, call someone on Craigslist, say, hey, I got a job for you. Just go to the Radio Shack, say you're with corporate.
Corporate hired you.
And then bring all the stuff to my house.
The Radio Shack van. The wacky Z100 morning van.
You got to write like the S backwards.
Yeah. Oh, shit. She's taking too long.
She's listening to us. We're so wacky here in the corporate office.
Hello? Yes. Hello?
Okay, so I just talked to my manager, and he told me to get your information, and we'll call you back. Because he said that's no right.
What do you mean? I don't have a right. Of course I have a right. This is my job.
No, but I need your phone number, and he will call you and talk to you personally.
Who's your manager? Is he there?
His name is Ross. He told me to get your phone number and your password, and he'll call you back.
My password?
Yeah, he says that every corporate should have the password or something.
Oh, the password is radio?
Can I get your information, please? I'm sorry, I can't. I'm just an associate. I'm just following what he told me.
Well, you're stupid. The password is Radio Shack with a 5.
Wow, hey, you know what? You don't call me stupid. Excuse
me. I just did, stupid.
How about I'm going to hang up on you, and you can talk to my manager. Bye.
Stupid!
So, did you hear that ringtone in the background? I've heard that at 3 different Radio Shacks. I was hearing it last night, too.
What is that?
Maybe it's the brand of cordless phone they use? I don't know. It's weird. Yeah. It's weird.
She's smart. She talked to the real manager.
She talked
to a manager last time.
I'm impressed with that she actually...
Yeah.
She took the initiative to... She used common sense.
Yep.
Good for her.
Good girl.
So, like, in Texas, well, no, I don't want to name all the states, but, yeah, 3 different states, I've heard that exact same ringtone at a Radio Shack. It's kind of weird.
Interesting.
It's like in the corporate manual, you must use, in the AT&T Slimline phone, use ringtone number.
That sounds like an annoying ringtone.
Yeah. Hey, do you have time to maybe just call one more customer before you leave? Or do you really need to get going?
No, I got time for one.
Okay, do you want to call about a HoverMax UFO toy?
Yeah.
Okay, let me paste the info in the Skype for you. I wonder if those have cameras. Should we Google it real quick?
I'm on it.
Okay. HoverMax with 2 X's UFO.
LED remote control UFO HoverMax. Hovers 30 feet high.
Probably didn't have a camera. That'd be cool if you could say, yeah, we got the images off your camera. Fucking pervert. So you ready?
Yes.
Okay, here goes. Charles. Say he started an interstellar war. Hello?
Is Charles clean there? Clean?
He's not here right now. He's at work. Can I take a message? Oh.
Well, he returned a Propel RC HoverMax UFO toy to Radio Shack. I'm calling from Radio Shack Corporate. Radio Shack, the Radio Shack store.
Yeah.
Do you know about this?
No.
Do you know that he bought a UFO, like a gyrocopter that flies 30 foot high? Hello?
No, he didn't buy anything like that, as far as I know. I don't see why he would have. He's 60, 70 years old, you know?
Well, he returned it here. I got his signature. He bought it. It was purple. He took it back here to Radio Shack. Maybe he's perverted or something. I don't know. listen, let them know that the FAA is here. There's a person from the FAA, and they say they tracked the UFO toy over an airport, and they're very upset about it, I guess.
What?
Yeah.
This is all crazy. Yeah.
He flew this drone over the airport over restricted airspace, and they're taking a report, I guess.
Okay. How about I give you his work number, and you can call him at work?
Give it now.
Or something, because I have no clue about any of this.
Okay.
Hold on a second, please. Scotty, what's your dad's work number? I need it. It's really important. Okay, it's 36.
Okay, I got it. Thank you.
You're welcome. Bye.
Bye, honey. Bye.
So I guess we should call quickly.
Yes.
Did you hear that? She's like, it's the cops. And she's like cursing and stuff.
Let's hit a radio check. Jeez.
May I help you?
Yeah, I need to speak to an employee there, Charles Klein. I'm calling from Radio Shack.
Sure, one moment.
Thank you. I'm calling from Radio Shack.
Hello?
Yeah, hi. This is Mark with Radio Shack. Is this Chris? I'm sorry, Charles Klein? Klein?
Klein.
All right.
Yes, Charles Klein.
Clean, gotcha. Yeah, I see what? You've returned a Propel RC Hovermax UFO, LED remote control UFO toy.
I returned a UFO toy?
Yes.
I don't know.
Yes, you did. Did you or someone you know buy a UFO helicopter toy here at Radio Shack that got returned under your name with your phone number at home?
No. We did not return, or we did not buy a helicopter, a UFO helicopter, or we didn't return it.
Well, there's someone here from the NTSB, the National Transportation Safety Board. They say you flew this thing over an airport?
No.
Yes, you did.
Are you from a radio station?
No, I'm from Radio Shack. 701 no. Slater and what? Lacey.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So are you trying to scam us, or did someone take your information? Is that what's going on here? You returned
somebody
something, sir.
Somebody may have taken the information, but...
Did you return anything to Radio Shack?
No, I did not.
Yeah, you're a fucking liar, you motherfucker, you. You know that?
Who is this?
You're a fucking liar. My name's Cross, and I'm here at Radio Shack, and I've got an NTSB and an FAA agent here, and they're looking for whoever flew this stupid UFO over an airport, and it's returned. You returned it, sir. You're lying. Know. You're lying. You know you're in trouble. You know what you did.
You're an idiot.
Your mother's an idiot. We're having you.
Goodbye.
Yeah, goodbye. Fuck you. Fuck that guy.
Yeah, fuck that guy. That was weird. What do you think happened? How does that...
I think he really did it, and he doesn't want to admit to it.
Probably, yeah.
Like, oh shit, they're onto me!
I wonder if, like, maybe an employee bought it just to play with, and then they're like, oh, I'll just return it under this guy's account.
Under Chris, under Charles' name.
That's all I can think of. I mean, I don't see how they could make the mistake. They gave me the right name and the right phone number.
Yeah, he's like, oh no, I haven't returned anything to Radio Shack. Oh, okay.
He had to return something.
Yeah, he's full of shit.
Weird. Do you have time for one more?
I should get going. I'm sorry. I don't want to be late. I really need antibiotics.
You don't want to talk to Edward about his trimline foam?
Oh my God. I really would like to.
Yeah, I know. You gotta go.
I'm sorry.
Fine.
All right. Bye. Sure, it was fun. Thanks for having me on. Yeah. Sorry, I can't stay longer.
Make sure you pinch the nurse's ass and stuff.
Mm-hmm. I'll pinch my Hershey Kisses for her too.
Yes, of course. Why wouldn't you?
See you, buddy.
Bye.
Carly. Bye, everybody. Love you guys.
Woohoo! He's finally gone. I thought I'd never be rid of that guy. All right, so I guess I'm going to quit the show now. No, just kidding. I'll do a little bit more. I do want to try and shut down another store or two in that same area. By now, they're probably warning everyone in the area. Well, I don't know. Maybe. Who knows? Their 90s era fax machine is picking up. Actually, I don't know what that was. I want to do a customer survey is what I want to do. Because those last two Radio Shacks, they both had customers in them.
Thanks for calling Radio Shack. This is Richard. How may I help you?
Hi, this is William from the corporate office with Radio Shack.
Hello, William.
Hello. I was just calling to do the weekly customer survey. Do you have a customer in there I could speak with? Just do a quick survey with them?
I do have one customer, if he doesn't mind.
Okay, yeah, we'll let him know. We'll give him like a coupon for some free batteries.
All right, just a second. Would you like to do a corporate survey? He says no, thank you, sir.
Oh, no, he has to.
He has to.
I mean, there's no choice. He needs to do the survey. No survey, no sale. That's our policy.
No.
No, that's how it works.
Customer always has a choice.
No, the customer does not.
The customer.
You don't know how things work in the corporate world. You need to tell that customer you need to get on the phone right now. And he's gone. Strangely enough. Like, I will not quit doing this show today until I get at least, I have to put him on hold. One customer survey. That has to happen.
Thank you for calling Radio Shack, where we make it happen. This is Andrea speaking. How can I help you?
Hello, this is Douglas from the corporate office with Radio Shack.
Yep.
And hi, I was just calling to do the customer survey for the month. Do you have a customer in there we could speak with to just do a quick survey with them?
Not at the moment.
Oh, no. There's nobody in there at all? Like, nobody getting ready to come in?
No, it's fairly quiet here.
Huh. When's the last time you had a customer?
I don't know. 5 or 10 minutes ago?
Oh, wow, that's a long time. Yeah, I think at this point, this is just like the last straw. I didn't want to do this today, but we're going to have to close down your store permanently. Like, I think today should be the last day of your store to operate. We're going to have to close down immediately.
Oh, I'm not the manager.
That's okay. So it's fine. Do you have a key to the store? Can you lock up?
Yes, I can.
Okay, that would be perfect. We need to lock up the store, make sure nobody else gets in, and we'll go through the shutdown procedure.
Alrighty.
So I can hold while you lock up. Lock the door.
Give me just a moment, please.
Okay.
Ha ha!
What do you mean, ha ha? Am I supposed to be doing this? I'm going to print out the closing store forms.
Sorry about that. You still there?
Yes, I'm still here.
All right, what was your name? I'm sorry.
My name is Roy Gerbel from the corporate office.
Can you spell your name for me?
Sure, it's R-O-Y. And, we're just going to have to go ahead and close your location today.
And is there a number where I can reach you?
Sure.
I'm going to verify this with my district manager.
Oh, of course. Yeah, it's area code 214-666-6969. Mm-hmm. Extension 420.
Alrighty. What was your last name again? I'm sorry?
Gerbel.
Can you spell that?
Oh, sure. G-H-E-X... B-A-L.
Alrighty. I'll give you a call back in just a little bit.
Okay, great.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, honey baby.
Yep.
Sweetie tits. Hey, maybe after you close down, we can go out for ice cream together. Nope. Nope. That's the response I usually get when I ask a girl out for ice cream. Thanks for suggesting that. Do what now? Thanks for making me get shot down. Once again. I'm going to try one more. One more customer survey. Aw, Mr. Smorgenwood
is... Radio Shack, this is Steven.
Hello, this is Gary from the corporate office with Radio Shack.
Yep.
And I'm just calling to do the monthly customer survey. Do you have a customer in there I could speak with and do a quick survey with them?
We don't have any customers in the store right now, actually.
Oh, when's the last time you had one?
About 20 minutes ago.
Oh, geez, okay. That's what I was afraid of. I think we're going to go ahead and have your store closed down permanently. I'm going to go ahead and add you to the bankruptcy store closing list.
All right.
So,
I want to speak to my manager.
Oh, yeah, that'd probably be best.
This is Steve.
Hello, Steve. This is Roy from the corporate office with Radio Shack.
Okay.
And did you get the paperwork last week? Your store is going to be one of the five in your, or one of the three in your area closing down?
One second here.
Okay.
Check something here real quick. What's the store passcode?
Cactus. 5.
That's not matching.
Well, you probably didn't get the new one because you're closing down. You're not really on our priority anymore to give you out our secret passwords. Motherfucker.
Otherwise, you'd need to go through my district manager to do anything.
Well, he should have told you. I think he's being rebellious.
Who is this, really?
This is Roy from the corporate office.
Okay. Is there a number we can call you back at?
Yeah, the corporate office number, extension 420.
Okay, that's nice. Who is this?
Roy from the corporate office. You need to call me back, and then I'm going to ask you for the password when you call me, since you're such a smartass. And we're going to close down your store.
Okay.
It's all right, so call back right away.
All right. What's the number to corporate?
You know the number. You should have it right there. I'm an extension 420.
All right, have a nice day.
Bye, honey baby. Sweetie tits. All right, I'm going to try three stores here real quick and do a customer survey. Will not rest until it happens. I'm picking Radio Shacks out in the boonies, though. I think that's a stupid idea. So let me find a big city Radio Shack. Here's a big city Radio Shack. I think they'll be more likely to have people in their stores. Council Bluffs, Iowa. That's where Kay lives. Kay, the information operator.
Radio Shack, this is Danny.
Hello, this is Greg from the corporate office with Radio Shack.
Hi.
Hi. I'm just calling to do the monthly customer survey. Do you have a customer in there I could speak with?
No, I don't, actually.
Oh, there's nobody? No customers in there?
Nope, we're empty right now.
Huh, okay. When's the last time you had one?
I had a gentleman in here about 10 minutes ago.
It's really convenient
that he's not there. It tends to be pretty steady, but we'll get like one or two groups in here at once.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and mark you down as possibly closing permanently at that rate. So yeah, I'm going to go ahead and mark that down.
Okay.
That's what you get, you know.
Something else I can do for you?
Well, if there's not customers in there, why are you in there? Why don't you go outside and get a sign and spin it next to the street?
Well, there's only me here right now, sir.
Why don't you show some goddamn initiative?
All right. Well, you have a good day.
He doesn't like being told the truth. Truth hurts. Here we go. This one's in a shopping center. They've got to have someone, right?
Thanks, Paul. Radio Shack is Nelson.
Hello, this is Greg from the corporate office with Radio Shack.
Yep.
Hello, and I'm just calling to do the monthly customer survey. Do you have a customer in there I could speak with?
Hold on. I'm going to need the word of the week.
Cactus, 4.
Nope, that's wrong.
No, it's right. You didn't get the new word yet. You want to know why?
Why?
Because we're closing your store permanently. Because of your attitude.
Oh.
Yeah. What do you think of that?
That's interesting. Is there anything else I can help you with, sir?
It's not that interesting, really.
Anything else I can help you with?
It's not interesting at all. Why do you think it's interesting? You big stupid.
All right, I'm going to hang up now.
Good. Hang up. I'll be the one that has a job when you don't. Whatever. Yeah, Nova, I should do that. I should call a Radio Shack and get the password from them. But it's not a big problem, and I'm not going to be doing this much longer. I really want to do one customer survey before I go back to calling customers. Damn it. Damn it, damn it, damn it.
Hi, thank you for calling Radio Shack. This is Jesse.
Hello, Jesse. This is Roy from the corporate office with Radio Shack.
How are we doing?
Pretty good. I was just calling to do the monthly customer survey. Do you have a customer there we could speak with?
Yes, actually.
Okay, yeah, just let him know he gets like a coupon for some free batteries. It's just like a 1 minute survey.
I gotcha.
Thanks.
Hello?
Hi, is this a customer?
Yes.
Did he let you know that you're actually the 1 millionth customer at this location?
No.
Yes, you are. You get a... I'm calling from the corporate office with Radio Shack. Mm-hmm. And you get a very fast, just 30-second shopping spree of the store.
Of anything I want?
Yeah. Anything you can pick up and carry in your arms. You just can't go behind the counter. But anything else in the store, like on the when I say go, you'll have 30 seconds, and then the clerk there, he'll let you know when your 30 seconds is up.
Okay, should I give him the phone?
I'm just going to count down, and you just set the phone down real quick, run around, and get as much as you can until he says stop. So you ready to go?
I think so.
Okay, all right, here we go. Get ready. On your marks. Get set. Go, 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 go.
Hello, sir. I am actually going to ask you to do something for me real quick.
Okay.
What is the store passcode for the week?
Well, is that lady running around?
Yes, she is.
I'll tell you in 30 seconds. I was actually going to ask you that, though.
No, I need to hear that from you, or I'm unfortunately going to have to hang up the phone here.
Well, don't hang up yet. Like, what things has she picked up in her arms?
I need you to verify the store passcode before I'm going to give any more information.
Okay. Well, is she getting expensive stuff or cheap stuff?
She's grabbing like RC cars and like SD cards and stuff like that. Though, like I said, I need you to verify the store passcode, or I'm going to be forced to hang up the phone.
No, I'm not even with the corporate office. I'm just I'm a wacky morning DJ with the Skippy and Dippy show. We just thought this would be a funny bit for the morning show tomorrow.
Sir, I don't find this funny.
Well, of course you don't.
I have a customer here that's going to be extremely irate with me because of this.
Our listeners are going to LOL.
You told me that you were from the corporate office. I'm going to be passing along this information to my corporate office, and you might be in contact with our legal department. Have a good day.
No,
sir.
No, we won't. It's okay. You guys don't have any money. Holy cow. He's going to be like, legal department, and you need to have a word with the Skippy and Dippy show. I hope Carlito's still listening on his way to the doctor's. I hope he got to hear that. Okay, let me get set up for the thing. You know, the thing, to call up some more people. It's going to be hilarious. I'd say we're probably going to do another 45 minutes, maybe. Something like that. Of customer calls. I would like to revisit this whole thing, though, again. We need to mess with more Radio Shacks. Oh, and also, somebody, let me scroll up. I forget who it was, I'm sorry, but oh wait, here it is. Ishbu wants me to say a closing prayer with an employee, which I think is an amazing idea. So I think I should do that before we end. Oh wait a minute, hold on, okay. I know something we need to do. Actually, I really did, just out of curiosity, I want to know what kind of password they use at the corporate office. The password, the word of the day. So I'm just going to call 3 stores real quick and see if they'll give it to me. Just for the hell of it. They probably won't.
Thank you for choosing Radio Shack and what? This is Chase. How can I help you today?
Well, I'm calling from the corporate office.
Okay, hold on 1 second, darling.
Okay.
This is Cheryl.
Hi, Cheryl.
Yes.
This is Roy from the corporate office.
Yes.
Were you just trying to call us? It looks like someone was trying to call in and then it hung up. I thought that there might be a problem or something.
Not that I'm aware of. Did you try to call the corporate office?
No.
Nope.
Is this really Radio Shack? Because I picked up and you guys were there.
Yes, this is.
Oh, well, do you have the word of the day?
Give me 1 second. I'm working on it again.
Okay. This is a really weird call. Like, so nobody there called?
You mean word of the week?
Yeah, the word of the week. I'm sorry.
I see it. You tell me what it is.
Oh, no, you have to tell me.
I can't. It doesn't work that way.
Oh,
you
yes, it does.
Me.
No, no, my phone rang. My phone rang, and I picked it up, and it was that other person.
Hmm. It's a little on the weird side.
Yeah, I mean, I can't just be giving it out to anyone. So what is?
I can't give it out to anybody either.
What is the word of the week? Just tell me. It's okay.
It's not okay.
Okay, well, this was just a test from corporate. I just wanted to make sure you weren't going to give it out.
I don't do that.
You passed the test.
Well, that's a good thing.
Okay. All right. Well, have a nice day.
You too.
Bye.
Bye.
That was nice. Good for her for not falling for it. I have to make them think they called me somehow. Yeah, Dashie says it will work eventually, and it will. I'm 100% certain of that. I'm just not going to try more than, like, maybe 3 times. Because this is boring, and the word's probably going to be stupid anyway.
Hello,
corporate Radio Shack. Corporate, can I help you?
You call corporate.
I'm sorry, what?
You call corporate. I'm sorry, I don't know how to number down your number.
Oh, well, no. Yeah, I'm calling from the corporate office here in Texas with Radio Shack.
Oh, how are you?
Oh, pretty good. Were you needing something? Because our phone rang.
Oh, no. She doesn't know how it rang.
Oh, that's really weird. I wonder if there's...
Yeah, I have no clue.
Are you,
She said she called the 1-800 number, but it was for a telephone.
Oh, so she just called. Can I get the word of the week? Just to make sure.
The word of the week.
The word of the week?
Mm-hmm.
They asked us the word of the week?
Mm-hmm. We don't know it.
Oh, where do you usually keep it? Why don't you know it? You have to know it.
You know where it's at?
No. You didn't tell us none of it. Why? You didn't tell us none of it.
What about the word of last week?
The word of last week? Okay, yes, sir. I can't find it.
Ah, fucking shit.
Yeah.
Okay, well, you know, like, if stop making prank calls, because this is a waste of everyone's time. Jesus.
No, we're really with Radio Shack. Like, I really work here. It's not a prank call, but I don't know how exactly. I don't know how she dialed the number. She was trying to help a customer with his phone.
Are you the manager?
No.
Oh. Do you have the authority to fire her?
No, I don't. I'm
Shit.
Sorry.
Shit. Well, you tell her she's lucky.
Okay, I'll let her know.
Okay, well, thank you very much. Have a nice day.
No problem.
Bye. Well, shit. One more. I want to know what the word of the week is. She completely believed that she called me, though, at least. I gave up Mistress Morgan because they didn't have it. Like, they just don't have it. Their manager's probably not even there. It's not my fault. I should have had them, like, break into the office and dig it out. That'll teach them.
Radio Shack, this is Liv.
Corporate office, this is Roy. Can I help you?
This is Liv. How can I help you? This is Radio Shack.
Oh, this is Radio Shack? Which Radio Shack is this? Okay, and can I help you?
You called.
What? No, I didn't call. I just picked up the phone.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. I'm not sure what happened.
Oh, you didn't dial us?
No.
Oh, and you are with Radio Shack, or are you?
Yes.
Oh, what's the word of the week, then?
You have a very good day.
What was that giggle for? Ugh. Okay, one last try. This is the last time. I know I said 3, but I'm going to do 4. I really want that word of the week.
Tim Conray, check
the test. I'm in the corporate office. Can I help you?
Say this again.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm calling from the Radio Shack corporate office.
Yeah, this is Aaron speaking.
Oh, okay. And did you need something then?
Did I call you?
Yeah, my phone rang. I just picked up and you were there. Which store is this?
This is my store number just rang and I picked up and
That's odd.
I don't know if they disconnected, but we didn't call you.
Did someone else, another employee, call me or the manager? Is this the manager?
I'm the store manager. I'm looking at one of my associates. We didn't even have the phone. I just walked to pick up the phone and said, thanks for calling Radio Shack, and then, yeah.
That's very odd. Do you have the word of the week?
The word of the week?
Mm-hmm.
It is, I don't have it memorized at the top of my head.
This is so odd.
Fusion?
Fusion?
Yeah.
Like F-U-S-I-O-N?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. No, I'm just a hacker. I just wanted to get the word of the week.
Oh, okay.
I totally tricked you.
Is that okay? So I don't know if that's...
You don't know if that's what?
Do you work for Radio Shack?
Yeah, the word of the week. Fusion. Oh, don't try and tell me that's not it now. Come on.
I mean, I don't know if it... I mean, if it is, then you should know it.
No, I'm not with corporate. I'm just a hacker. I'm with Anonymous. I'm with Lizard Lounge.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, I just needed the word of the week so I can call the other store that's down the road from you. I'm going to totally trick them into something. So please don't call the store down the street and warn them, okay? Cause that
well, I mean, if you're not Radio Shack, why would I not warn them?
No, don't warn them, because I'm going to...
Now you're just committing a crime of lying.
No, the lying is not a crime.
Yes, it is. If you lie to a cop, you're going to jail, so therefore that's...
Are you a cop? Are you impersonating a cop? Impersonating a cop is a crime.
No, I'm not impersonating a cop.
Well, you just said
you're
a cop.
Impersonating someone else.
You just said you're a cop.
But you also said you was corporate.
It doesn't matter. I can lie. Lying is not illegal.
Okay.
You're not a local.
Why can I not tell my associates?
No, you can tell your associates at the store, but tell them not to call down the street and warn them.
Oh, well, that's...
Because I don't want them to know. Okay. Okay, time to call the store down the street. Ouch. Corporate office, can I help you? I don't know what that is. Oh. They're gone. It didn't hang up, and that beeping kept happening. I didn't know what it was, so I was hoping they were trying to pick up the phone and dial a number. So I was playing my dial tone for them. Let's see. So down the street from them, I think it's got to be this one. The word of the day is fusion. The word of the week, I mean.
Radio Shack, this is Jeremy. How can I help you?
Hey, this is Douglas from the corporate office with Radio Shack.
Yeah, how's it going, Douglas?
Oh, pretty good. Is this the manager?
The manager's actually not here right now.
Oh, that's weird. Your phone's ringing there in the background. I wonder who that could be. Hey, did you know your store is scheduled for closure?
Yeah, we did.
Yeah, but you're not supposed to be there today. Yesterday was your last day.
The 119th of Metcalf?
Yeah. What day do you show that it's supposed to close?
Well, they said we had the latest is on March 31st.
Oh, no, it was yesterday. Yesterday was the last day. We're going to need you to go ahead and close up and shut off the lights.
All right.
Can you lock the door? Are there any customers in there?
No, not right now.
Oh, thank God.
Well, yeah, there are, actually.
Oh, can you tell them to leave, please?
Yeah.
The word of the day, by the way, is fusion, if you want to confirm me. The word of the week, fusion. I don't know. We usually give that to managers just to let them know we're really with corporate.
Oh, okay.
I just wanted to use it because I don't get to use it that often. So, fusion.
Yeah.
Fusion. Fusion.
All right.
Yeah. Can you tell that customer to leave, though, real quick?
Yeah, I'll let them know.
Okay. And then I'll hold and just tell you a couple more things after.
All right, yeah.
And don't answer the phone.
Yeah, I won't.
Fuck it. I mean, it's just a customer. You don't want to talk to them.
Talking to this guy right here.
Don't pick up. Don't do it.
confusion.
What is going on? I still hear a phone ringing in the background. Law says, I like how their corporate security policy was subverted in 4 phone calls. I can hear him talking in the background. He must have walked away to talk to the customer. But then why does the phone sound so far away? That's weird.
This is Brad.
Brad? Who's Brad?
Brad Corbin.
Brad Corbin? Oh, you're Brad.
Yeah. No, you're Brad.
No, I'm not Brad.
Yeah.
Who could Brad be?
You.
No, I'm not Brad. I've never heard of Brad. What are you talking about? Why do you say I'm Brad?
Because somebody just told me you're Brad.
Who told you that? They're full of shit. No. Listen, fusion. Did I say I was Brad to the other person? Holy shit. I thought he said... Did I... Okay, you guys... Oh, do what now, says we have a leak. Someone listening right now called. Called the other Radio Shack and told them it's Brad. Maybe, I don't know. Or the other Radio Shack thinks they know who it is. It's their friend Brad. Brad Corbin. Jerks. Sloth says it's Nova. Someone kick Nova, quick, if Nova's in the room. Someone is subverting my... corporate policy subversions. God damn it. He just had to answer that other line. I told him not to. Maybe the other store like drove their car. They like raced it down to the other store. I think they could have done it that fast. It's not that far away. It's like a half mile. It's really close. Anyway, before I quit the show for the day, I would like to call some more Radio Shack people. So I'm going to call this first one. These returns are such Radio Shack things. Like this guy returned some desoldering braid and some soldering kit stuff. The next is an AT&T trimline phone. That sounds so old. I don't know what that is. A mono extension cable. Oh, a 10 pack of jumper leads. And some 45-foot, 18-gauge stranded hookup wire. Where are people going to buy this kind of thing once Radio Shack's gone?
Hello?
Hello, is this... I was calling for Ridge, Gordon. I'm calling from Radio Shack.
Just a moment.
All right.
It's a call from Radio Shack.
Hello?
Hello, Ridge. I'm calling from the Radio Shack. This is Steve.
Hello.
Hello. You returned some desoldering braid and soldering kit stuff.
Yeah.
And you also returned solder, right?
No.
Okay. Yeah, I'm just making sure. I'm testing you. No, we know that you use the soldering kit stuff and the desoldering braid. Like there's little bits of solder on it, so we know you used it and then you returned it.
Okay. It's in a sealed package.
No, we see where you resealed it.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did. You probably used the heat from your soldering iron to like seal it back up.
I didn't do anything like that.
Yes, you did, because we can see right here on the end of the soldering braid, it's all frayed.
I didn't do anything like that.
You big scammer! You're a scam artist. And we can see.
What's your point?
My point is you shouldn't be doing this to people. Come on, we're in enough trouble as it is. We're about to go bankrupt. And you're here scamming us for $3
or
whatever.
Well, I didn't do anything like that.
Yes, you did.
So I don't get the point of this call.
Who else did it if you didn't do it?
The package is sealed. What are you talking about?
I'm calling to shame you. Shame on you. Shame on you, Rich.
Okay, well, piss off.
Shame on you. Shame, shame, shame.
All right.
motherfucker. Motherfucker, goddamn it. He didn't get nearly enough shame. Shame him again.
You've reached 36. You've reached 36.
Whatever. The joke's on Ridge, because guess what? Guess what? We gave him counterfeit cash back. So, good luck not getting arrested for that, Ridge. Sloth says in the chat room, I gotta be honest, I prefer shopping online at this point. And I agree. But, like, there's so many times when I'm, you know, like, just for audio, for show stuff, like for my mixer, for my computer, it's just so convenient to just drive across town 10 minutes to Radio Shack and pick up what I need. And it's all overpriced. Like, I'll get these little, you know, RCA to quarter-inch jack adapter things, and it's like $9 for one. It should be like a dollar or two. That's what I would pay online. Even with shipping, it'd be much cheaper to buy online. So it's stupid to buy from Radio Shack, but it's really convenient. I'm going to miss that about Radio Shack. The Radio Shack I loved, though, they died 10 years ago. Radio Shack, you guys, you youngins don't even know. Radio Shack used to be an awesome store. They used to hire like geeks, you know, just neckbeard people that actually knew what they were doing. I bet you if the old Radio Shack was still around today, they'd all be smoking vape cigarettes and using bitcoins. They'd have Linux machines in their store, on their Tandy computers. All right, I'm going to call about this AT&T Trimline phone. Hi, Mr. Smorgan. Hi, Mr. Smorgan. Can't hear you.
Hello.
Hey.
Can you hear me?
Hey, yeah, I can hear you now.
Awesome.
What do you think? Like, when you were a kid, do you remember when Radio Shack, they used to sell electronic just circuit board kits? You remember that back in the
Yes, I do, actually. Didn't they also have that in the Sears catalog?
Maybe. I don't know.
I think so.
Yeah. But you remember the 70s, right?
Yeah. Like it was yesterday.
Yep. You want to call Edward about his AT&T Trimline phone?
Sure. Okay, you start it just because I have the sound coming out of the computer instead of my mic thing, so I'm just going to fix that.
Okay, all right. You can have the next one then. Remember, the word of the day is fusion. Word of the week, everyone. That's going to be the title of my show, Fusion.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Is this Edward?
Yes, it is.
I'm calling from Radio Shack. You returned a Trimline phone yesterday?
Yes, uh-huh.
Remember that?
Yes, I sure do.
What'd you return it for? Because to be honest, it sounds like you're talking on a 1950s phone right now, and like the microphone is just all degraded, and you sound like shit.
No, I can't help it. That phone didn't work. This phone does work.
Oh, no.
You've had it for a long time.
I hate to tell you this, but that does not work. You sound like garbage. Like, is this one of those Western Electric phones, like from the 60s?
Oh, I don't know. Let me see where it is. Hold on.
Does it have a dial on it? Does it have a dial? Do you have to dial numbers?
No, it has buttons. Push buttons. We've had it for maybe 10 years. Hold on.
Is it a big, bulky thing? Does it hang on the wall?
It could hang on the wall. We don't hang it on the wall, but the one we bought from you that didn't work could hang on the wall, too.
Yeah.
We just set it down. It's one right by the bed my wife uses.
You need
and
to just...
I talk to her, it sounds fine.
Oh, no. You sound like crap. You sound like shit. You sound like shit.
Well, I'll tell you, when my wife calls
shit.
Me on the phone, on my cell phone, it sounds normal.
Maybe so, your wife's...
You must have a poor connection.
No, maybe your wife's deaf and she needs to fix her hearing aid. But you sound like garbage. Fucking garbage.
I think this conversation is through. You have a good day.
Hey,
goodbye.
Hey. Why don't you... Do you think it was just a bad connection?
No, I think it was his phone. His phone legitimately sounded like a hobo phone.
Yeah. You should call and say you're the manager and say just tell him to enjoy his hobo phone.
Okay. What's his name again?
Edward Perry. Maybe he has one...
Good afternoon.
Hi there. Is this Edward?
Yes.
Hi, Edward. It's Kendra calling from Radio Shack Corporate. Okay, the line seems to be slightly better, but it appears you still have a hobo phone that you should probably invest in a new phone.
Well, I invested in one and it didn't work.
Well, so it's still not working, sir. Tell him to you do a really crappy job at buying phones, it seems.
I bought it from you folks. Okay.
Well, you didn't make the right choice. That's why we have various different brands that we carry. But it's people like you returning items that have caused us to have to close all the stores.
You have a wonderful day. Goodbye.
You're a jerk.
That's exactly what those, you know the old style phones with the dials, or, you know, the ones that the phone company used to lease to people?
Like a rotary phone?
Yeah, like a rotary, but it can have push buttons too, you know, the big bulky things.
Okay. Oh yeah, that you put on, yeah.
Yeah, that's exactly what they sound like after decades. The microphones, they just kind of dissolve and stuff inside there. And they sound like crap. Well,
he sounded pretty old himself.
Oh, I was thinking maybe he was a smoker and he lost his voice and he uses one of those robot things.
Oh, the tracheotomy. Is it tracheotomy?
Yeah.
Something like that.
That's it. Maybe he had a perfect phone and he's just talking through one of those.
That's what it sounded like.
Let's see. Do you want to talk to some... Oh, the rest of it is just electronic stuff. So,
what do you mean electronic stuff?
Like a male-to-male patch cable. Stereo cable.
Oh, and they returned it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we can always ream them out for returning items and guilt trip them for being the reason that we're closing all the stores and laying off a bunch of people.
Yeah, or guilt trip him for being a homophobe because he returned a male-to-male patch.
A male-to-male cable. Okay, that's great. What's his name?
Ryan Cooper.
Brian, okay.
I'm going to try him again.
That was a brilliant idea.
Well, at least I have his number still for later.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna... Well, it's still... Maybe he's on the phone. Maybe that's why there's no machine.
I was gonna say, I think it's possible that Radio Shack sent out, a transmission to all their stores, because when you were trying to get the word of the week, I called a Hawaii store and spoofed my number to corporate office and tried to get it.
Mm-hmm.
And he was very suspicious.
The mailbox belonging to...
He wasn't at first, though.
...is full and cannot accept new...
So I have a feeling a transmission went out or something like that.
Oh, shit.
Mm-hmm.
Did you hear that lady's machine?
No.
She's like, the mailbox belonging to Cooper!
Oh, God.
It was like his wife. Brian Cooper's wife.
Oh, Brian Cooper, that guy.
Yeah, sick of his shit.
He's pussy whipped.
Okay, so you're going to have to talk to Conrad Gudgel.
Oh, God.
Just Conrad.
Okay, did he return?
Yesterday, he exchanged. He returned a mono extension cable. Here, I'll paste it because this is complicated. And he purchased, in exchange for it, an 8-foot speaker extension cable.
Okay. Conrad sounds like the name of some football player for high school or something. Jock.
Back in his youth. Now he's old and just buys speaker cable.
Hello.
Hi there. Can I speak with Conrad, please?
He's at work. Can I take a message?
Oh, is he? Yeah, of course. It's Kendra calling. I'm calling from Radio Shack corporate office in regards to an item that he exchanged with us the other day.
Okay.
Are you familiar with that item and that situation?
I'm not.
No? No, so
no,
you had no
I'm
part
sorry.
In it?
I'm not.
Oh, okay. Because he actually, he bought a virtual, one of those ocular rifts? He was asking about the virtual reality porn, but he ended up having some problems with the item, so he ended up returning it. But there seems to be a little issue with that return. So could you get him to call us back maybe when he gets home?
Okay.
And you can just let him know it was about the Oculus Rift porn that he was exchanging yesterday.
Okay. And what number does he call?
The head office here is 1-877-RADIO-SHACK.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
All right, thanks.
Bye, bitch.
Bye.
That was rude of you, saying bitch to her.
Hey, was that she seemed too pleasant.
Yeah, you can't be too mean to her.
No, well.
So, was that really Radio Shack's number?
No.
Oh, okay. I was going to say, that wouldn't work too good on cell phones or Skype or anything else.
No. I didn't know what to tell her, so Just wanted to make it weird when he gets home from work.
Did you buy porn at Radio Shack, honey?
I can't believe we closed the store down today.
That's amazing.
Reach the Brown Wheelhair residence. Please leave us a message.
Shit.
Okay, well, that's all for that store, that location. So I only have about 20 numbers left. If you're up to calling some more at a different location.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Oh, gosh.
You're so unprofessional.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. That was a different ringtone than I heard the first time. Do you have personalized ringtones for everyone you know?
Yeah.
One of those people?
I think that was my delivery company. I get them to deliver me food and stuff when I'm too lazy to go out.
I see. Do they just call you? Like, do you want anything today? You haven't called yet.
They're almost at that point.
What have you got on the way today?
I have, I'm picking up some veterinary cat food from my vet. Two packs of cigarettes and a carton of milk.
Ah, that kind of delivery company.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I thought you meant like takeout or something.
Oh, no, no. It's more common stuff that most people leave the house for.
This is Jeff.
Hi, Jeff.
Yes.
Hey, it's Bill from Radio Shack.
Bill from Radio Shack.
Yeah. Hello. You returned a Cat 5 Combinator.
Yep.
Yep, yesterday?
Yes.
So we just looked at the chip on it, you know, and it shows us, like, all the traffic that went through it when you used it.
Okay.
And basically we know that you're with Lizard Lounge.
With what?
You're a hacker. You're a hacker. You've been hacking with this thing. And you can't do that.
No, not at all.
No, we looked at
hacking.
We looked at the chip, and we know.
Well, I don't care what you looked at. I have fiber optic internet
for your hacking.
Okay.
Uh huh.
I'm not hacking. I don't know anything about computers. I'm 57 years old. No,
you're with Lizard Lounge. You're one of those people that shut down Xbox Live on Christmas morning.
Okay. So what's your point?
Well, I think you're an asshole for being a hacker.
Oh, okay.
And you're lucky I don't turn you in.
But you can turn me in because I don't hack. So yes. Do whatever you want to do.
Then how come someone was using this thing to hack just the day before you turned it in?
I have no idea.
Is your wife hacking? Is your wife a hacker with Lizard Lounge?
All right, dude. Talk to you later.
I think, man, you're full of shit. Full of shit. Okay, whatever. I don't know what a Cat 5 Combinator is. Maybe it meant connector. I don't know.
I'm sorry. The person you are trying to reach has a voicemail box.
That has not been set up yet.
Wasn't that a hackable voicemail?
It probably was. Weirdly enough, my asterisk thing I use, I can't hit pound or star with it. So, it's stupid. I need to get a new program.
That seems wrong.
I love this Blink program I use, but it doesn't have star or pound.
Damn it.
Whenever I need to hit star or pound, I transfer the call over to my desk phone and hit it.
Oh. You can't do it through Skype, hey?
Oh, I guess I could. I don't usually have Skype running.
I'm sorry. The person you are trying to reach has a voicemail
do
box
it, do
that
it.
Has not been set up
you
yet.
You did.
Try your call again later. Goodbye.
I don't even have the dial pad. I think the dial pad doesn't show up anymore if we're not making phone calls
really? With
Skype.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that like a new Skype update?
I think so, because we used to be able to do it anytime we wanted.
No, if you go to right beside the red hang-up sign, there's the star, and it says show dial pad if you click it.
Star.
Like right, the button right beside to the left of the red hang-up button.
I see a plus.
Yeah, that's
fine. Oh, that's show dial pad. That's not a star. Okay.
Okay,
look, I can hit things.
It's close. It's close to a star.
Okay. Thanks for showing me how to use Skype.
You're welcome.
I'm such a dummy.
No, you're not.
Nobody's answering at this location.
Hmm. You're calling a store?
Oh, well, the customers at this one store.
Oh, okay.
Like, hi, you've reached 425.
God damn it.
This one looks like a foreigner. Damn foreigners.
Maybe they've called all the customers and warned them.
Yeah, could be. That'd be fast acting if they did that.
They're not that good.
You want to talk to Richard Cook about his three-way headphone splitter he returned?
He returned it and didn't... Oh, man. Okay.
I bet you he had a breakup, so he couldn't take walks with his girlfriend and listen to their iPhones
together.
Oh,
my gosh.
So wow. That's probably what happened.
Yep. What's his name? Sorry.
Richard Cook.
Whoa. Whoa.
Don't spill your shit.
Oh, my cat's knocking things over. This is my favorite part of your show, always.
Where the phone rings?
Yeah.
It's everyone's.
Mm-hmm.
But I always cut out the ringing to keep them wanting more.
That's the best thing to do. Though you should maybe once a year have a show
your
just
call
ringing.
Has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system.
I should do a show where I do the intro. I'm like, okay, we're going to call this person. And then it's just ringing for an hour.
Like an hour and a half. Yeah, that would be good.
Yeah, and then at the end it's like, okay, guess they're not going to pick up. Today's show is sponsored by blah, blah, blah.
Oh, that's great. That's a great idea.
But now I gave away the idea, so everyone...
It's okay. Just wait a little while. All these stoners will forget.
That's true. I really want to talk to him about his breakup.
Yeah, you have the best ideas.
No, you have the best ideas.
No, not even close. When did you get all these numbers? Last night?
Yep.
Wow. Last night. Was it pretty easy?
Oh, yeah. It's incredibly easy. It was hard at first because they don't ask for phone numbers anymore like they used to.
Mm-hmm.
But they do ask for phone numbers on returns.
Oh.
And I found out they keep their returns receipts in a thing called the lockbox.
The lockbox.
So I'm just like, hey, could you just open up your lockbox and get out the receipts and read me the info? And it's like, that's the magic word. That's the buzzword they respond to.
Fusion lockbox.
By the way, fusion.
Fusion.
Everyone listening today, for the rest of the week, I want you to use the word fusion as much as possible in everyday
word. Word of the week is fusion.
Use it in a sentence. Do you have a good sentence, Mr. Smorgan?
Yes, I heard an interesting story about one time this couple were having sex on the beach and some fusion happened and they literally became stuck inside the male, inside the female, and they had to go to the hospital. It's a very, very rare thing that happens, like one out of every million times or something. Happens with suction and weirdness. That. But yeah, you can get you can get fusioned together.
I think I've heard about that on Distorted View, the Distorted View podcast. He loves talking about weird stuff like that.
Yeah, it's quite weird. But I think that's a good use of the word fusion.
Yeah.
Sex fusion.
I'm surprised you had a word all in story. My sentence is, I called the guy at Radio Shack and asked for the word of the week. He said it was fusion. There, that's my sentence.
That's very good. Very appropriate.
And it's a true story, too.
Yes, it is. So was mine, I think.
Okay, how about a wireless Linksys router?
Okay.
This person's name is Laurel Stockton.
Sounds like an older man.
Yeah.
Or Laurel? Is that a female name? I don't know.
I think that could be either, maybe. It's a wireless router.
It's probably a female. Or, female.
Danimal. I want to be fusioned with Morgan.
You can read it.
Elky, I got fusioned.
You had reached.
Oh, your kid is so cute and adorable. I admire her so much.
Vermin spawn.
That message on your machine is not annoying at all.
No. Isn't that crazy? Everyone thinks their own fucking kids are just the best goddamn kids in the world.
I'm proud to say I never once in my entire life had my kids do my answering machine message.
Can I give you a round of applause for
sure,
that?
Thanks.
That's annoying as fuck. Yay,
Thank you. All right, let's call back. I'm glad we're in agreement on that.
Yes, I hate that.
Okay, this is the same person, Laurel, wireless router.
Okay. Same type of people that just brag on their Facebook all the time about, you know, average kids, average things their kids do as if they're, you know.
They post a billion pictures.
Yeah, it's not like they solved cancer, you know.
You have reached 4, 2, 5, 3, 7, 9.
They don't even know how to enunciate their words.
Yeah, stupid kid. I bet she's in special ed. I'm a horrible person.
No, no.
This is horrible.
Hello? Hello, Sandy?
Yes?
Hi, Sandy. It's Kendra calling from Radio Shack Corporate Office. How are you doing today?
I'm fine.
Great, great. I was just calling about the return you made the other day with the DVI to HDMI cord.
Yes.
Okay, I was just wondering if I could inquire exactly what the reason was for the return.
You know what? I didn't need it.
Oh, why'd you buy it then?
The package wasn't even open. And
well, why did you buy it if you didn't need it? That seems kind of silly. Wasting your time as well as ours.
Well, what's silly is that you're calling about a cheap part.
Do you realize it's customers like you, Sandy? We're closing more than half of our stores in North America. And if people didn't go out and make meaningless purchases that they later had to return, you know,
are you kidding
wasting
me?
Our
Listen
time?
To me. We had an old TV. We bought a Blu-ray player,
mm-hmm.
and we needed that connection.
Well, why haven't you upgraded to like a flat-screen LCD monitor? Why do you still have a hobo TV?
No? I love that noise she made. She's like, All right, I'm going to be your supervisor.
Yeah, be my supervisor. Teach her a lesson.
I love you said it's her fault for the bankruptcy. When I smack you, you need to cry out in pain, okay?
Okay.
Hi, this is Sandy. Leave me a message and I'll get back to you. Wait. Thanks.
Let me try one more time. I want to do this
live. I have
live.
A feeling she'll answer. Third time's a charm.
I need a gunshot sound effect. I want to shoot you.
You can do that, mistress. Mistress Arby.
Thanks. I really need to get a gunshot sound effect. She's not picking up because she's so pissed.
Yeah, she didn't like me very much. Here's some gunshot
Hi,
sound effects.
Andy, leave me a message and I'll get back to you. Thanks.
At the tone, please record your message. When you have finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options. To leave a callback number, press 5.
Hello, Sandy. This is Roy from the Radio Shack. I just wanted to apologize for my employee's conduct earlier. I guess she talked to you and I heard the phone call. I couldn't believe she was like that. I just wanted to give you a sincere apology about that. Kendra.
I said I was sorry.
Kendra, get over here. Get it.
I said I was sorry.
Over. Okay, Kendra, come here. Come here.
I said sorry.
No, you do not talk to customers like that.
Ow! Why did you hit me? Ow! I said
now,
I was
now go,
sorry.
Now go. Get out. Out of the store. Out.
I quit.
Get out. No. You're fired.
You can't
get
fire
out.
Me for that.
Get the fuck out, Kendra.
Fuck Radio Shack.
She's gone. Oh, my hands really hurt.
What did you hit?
I was just clapping my hands. I guess I have weak hands.
Toughen up, Brad. Come on.
Holy shit.
Yeah, you gotta toughen up if a little bit of clapping hurts.
Yeah. Carlito, I sent him a picture of my hands once. Don't ask, but he told me I had really girly hands.
Do you have a hand fetish or something?
No, it was for... I was doing a graphic thing for him. My hand was involved.
A graphic? Like graphic sexual thing?
No, a picture. Photoshops of things.
It still sounds pretty... pretty questionable.
Well, the point is I have girly hands and apparently they can't take a beating.
Are they soft? Are they nice and soft?
I guess so. I haven't slapped a hoe in years.
Well, you gotta get on that.
Seriously, they're stinging now. Okay.
Well, jeez.
I was hitting really hard though. I really wanted you to feel it.
I like it really hard. It's okay.
Yep. Don't we all? Okay. I still have a couple more from the same location.
Oh God, loud vehicle. You're the boss.
Okay. Well, good. I'm going to call Marge then.
Okay.
I need to end the show. It's been 3.5 hours. Holy crap.
Hello?
Hi, Marge.
Hello?
Marge?
Uh-huh.
Hey, Marge. Yeah? It's Roy from the Radio Shack.
Uh-huh.
And you were in here yesterday. You returned this HDMI cable.
Oh, my husband did, yeah.
Well, no, it has your name on the receipt, so you're responsible.
Oh.
That's what
responsible?
Yeah.
For
because,
what?
Because he cheated us. He cheated us. He,
what?
He didn't return the HDMI cable. He put an old, like a RCA jack from the 70s. He put that in the package.
Oh, and he might have accidentally done that.
Oh,
he didn't
sure.
do it on purpose.
You know what? Everyone that cheats us, they're like, oh, it was an accident. I mean, how do you
no,
do
No, seriously. You're starting to get insulting. As far as I know,
insulting.
It was what he bought.
You know, our company's
well,
going...
We'll definitely look and bring you the right thing. Is that what you're suggesting?
Our company's going bankrupt because of people like your husband and you.
Listen to me. Well, if we didn't bring the right thing, we will make it right. You don't need to be like that.
You're a couple
that
of
is
scammers.
Insulting. Yeah, that's why you're going bankrupt. You won't talk to people
I
in
am
a
talking
nice
to you.
Way.
The old return.
I told you, we'll bring it. If we brought the right wrong one, we'll bring the right one.
The old return swapperoo. You think you can't get caught.
It's but not true. I'm
caught you this time.
I'll ask my husband what happened, but I'm sure we have the right one here if we didn't bring the
I
right one.
I looked at your account. You have a long history of returns like this.
I do not. I've only bought one thing there.
Oh, no, you can't.
My cord for my Kindle and maybe a battery that didn't work right.
Oh, yeah, you returned the battery, because that's in here, right? You returned the battery?
What are you talking about?
Did you return the battery?
The battery? A year ago, maybe?
Yeah.
I bought a battery and returned it because it was the wrong size?
That's in here. Like, you bought a Kindle battery, and you just put, like, a AA battery in there.
No, I don't know what you're talking about. I bought a Kindle cord because my cord had broken, and I kept it. I have it here.
Well, the point is you're a scammer, and you're going to hell for doing things like that.
I don't know who you are, but I'm going to call this number back and see exactly who I'm talking to, and then I'm going to call the police or something. I don't understand how someone can be
I'll call
so
the police. You're going to call the police? Yeah, Radio Shack's
mad. Who is this, anyway?
Radio
What's
Shack's
your name?
Angry with me because I keep scamming them. Do something. Arrest them.
What? Who is this? What's your name?
Roy.
Are you ashamed to give me your name?
No, I gave it to you already. You're just old and you forget
Let
things
Let me
quickly.
Have it again, the last name, too.
Okay, Roy Gerbel.
Make Roy sure. Gerbel, yeah. And you're at the Radio Shack up by Fred Meyer?
Write it down this time so you don't forget it, you old bat.
You are the biggest jerk I have ever dealt with, and I think it's got to be some kind of scam you're pulling.
At least I don't scam
but
people.
Believe me, I'm calling somebody, and we'll be up there with the right piece if we have it here.
Okay, yeah, if you could do that, that'd be great. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Big jerk.
Oh, my God.
I love that I love that big jerk at the end.
Big jerk. You have to get the last word in. Oh my God. You should add that to the end of all your signatures. Brad Carter, biggest jerk ever.
Brad That's Carter,
a good title
big jerk.
For you.
I need a business card. Brad Carter, big jerk.
Yes, you do.
Hello?
Hello, Doug.
This is him.
Hey, it's Roy from the Radio Shack.
Oh, yeah, Roy. What's up?
Oh, nothing. We saw that you returned this thing yesterday.
Yeah.
And what'd you do that for? Like, what'd you buy it for if you didn't want it?
Is there a problem?
Well, no, I don't see why you're wasting everyone's time. Like, why'd you buy it in the first place?
Did you just call me up to harass me about this?
I'm not harassing you. This is a single phone call. It's business related.
Okay.
Because you gave us your phone number.
You sound kind of upset.
I am. We're going bankrupt because of people like you.
People like me?
Yeah, you people.
I didn't use that thing. I didn't open it up.
Well, it's not like we can just put it back on the shelf. We have to send it back.
Well, I don't...
I'm sorry about that. I guess you should change your return policy.
Well, maybe you should just stop scamming us. Stop scamming
okay,
us all the time.
Sorry. Hey, I won't buy anything from you ever again.
Hey, motherfucker. Don't get an attitude with me.
Excuse me?
I said, don't get an attitude with me, please, sir.
You called me a motherfucker, sir.
You are being a motherfucker.
Your name is Roy?
Your attitude is the attitude of a motherfucker.
Roy, could I get your last name, please?
Sure, it's Stevens.
Roy Stevens, thank you.
And you're a motherfucker, Doug. All right. I think I won that argument. That'll teach Doug to be a bad customer. Mistress Morgan! Mistress Morgan!
Hello!
Hey, Mistress Morgan!
I'm back!
I'm calling up another person at a new store.
Awesome.
She got a 6-foot power cord. Exchange.
Stupid.
Or he.
Hello?
Hello, Edward?
Yeah!
It's Roy from the Radio Shack.
Yes, Roy.
You were here yesterday.
I was.
Remember?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, and you exchanged that 6-foot power cord?
I did.
Okay, I have a recording of you confirming it, so you can't deny it in the rest of this call. It's been said, and it's on record.
Fine, what is this call all about?
Well, you know what it's about. You returned the wrong cord.
Don't. What do you mean I returned the
wrong cord? Listen to you. You're such a good actor. Have you worked in community theater before?
All right, I'm hanging up right now.
Oh, yeah, I bet. Okay. You're like, I can't deal with, consequences. I'm just going to hang right up.
What a pussy.
I know. Thinks he could just come around and scam us.
Jeez.
I don't know. He doesn't deserve a call back, does he?
No, he doesn't. He was too old and crotchety.
Do you want to talk to someone about their VTech cordless phones with built-in caller ID?
Okay. Uses home phones these days?
Not me, that's for sure.
Unless they're running some sort of phone sex operation.
Yeah. No comment. this lady's name is Daisy, so she's...
Oh, yeah, she's definitely running a...
She's approximately...
Illicit, a weird phone sex.
She's approximately 100 years old, would be my guess.
Daisy. Well, she's either 100 years old and, like, a farm girl, or she's a stripper.
Yep.
One who's addicted to coke.
She's either 100 or 18.
Hello. Please leave a message after the tone.
That must be her pimp.
That's her new cordless phone. Or her old one. Oh, it's busy now. Did you get
Hello.
A new...
Hello. Please leave a message.
Did you get a new mic recently?
I've had it always. I just didn't use it before because I was too lazy to plug it in. I didn't realize how much better it actually sounds. So.
I see. Yeah. Sound really good. Did you buy it at Radio Shack?
No, I just got it on Amazon.
You're the reason Radio Shack's going bankrupt.
It's not me. It's not me.
I bet if your local location closes down, it's... You can blame yourself.
Okay.
It's like when my video store closed down near me. I take full responsibility because I used to go in there and just snap pictures of movies I wanted to download.
Download? When I got home. Yeah. It's the smart way to do it.
That's browse their new releases. I'm like, I'm going to get this one when I go home.
That's the wise way to do it. I'm actually surprised more Radio Shacks aren't gone already. I'm surprised they stuck around as long as they did.
Yeah. I guess just because they sold cell phones.
Yeah, that's true.
You'd think they could keep that up, because there's lots of Verizon, and there's lots of cell phone stores. Why can't Radio Shack just make their money that way?
They just need to man the fuck up.
Yep.
Yeah.
Stop handing out the word of the week to
pranksters. Exactly. We can always mess around with Target Canada store sometime in the next few weeks, because all of them in Canada are closing down as well. So
I heard about that.
They will be fun to mess with, I think.
Why are they closed? I didn't really read about it.
Oh, because they overestimated the market in Canada, I guess. Okay. And they didn't include the same items that they sell in Target stores in the States up in Canada.
They weren't selling enough igloo supplies.
Yeah, and maple syrup. So, yeah, they're pulling out not even 2 years in.
Oh, they've only been there for 2 years?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
That's weird. I have no idea what...
They wasted something like $11 billion already.
Holy crap.
It was some ridiculous number, yeah.
Do you guys have Walmarts up there?
Yeah, of course we do.
I mean, lots. Like, are they everywhere like they are here?
They're in most, yeah, in most cities. We finally just got our first Walmart like 10 years ago in the city.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. We even have Walmart supercenters some places.
Wow.
Yeah.
We just got a Walmart in the town I live in just 3 or 4 years ago.
Yeah, it's nice, but at the same time, I feel bad when I shop there, yeah. But then it's cheap.
I never went there once, but then our Albertsons closed down, so I had to. I didn't want to go to the other place. I don't like their grocery
store. It's a love-hate thing.
Yeah, it's really cheap. I'm saving lots of money, though, compared to when I went to Albertsons.
And I'm sure with it being in the States, you must get to witness a lot of people of Walmart, interesting folk that probably shop at your Walmart.
Fat people on their scooters.
Yeah, wearing ridiculous clothes that they should never wear.
It's so weird because I don't see those same people at Target or any other store in town. It's just, I go to Walmart and it's just a whole different...
It's weird.
It's like they don't even live here.
Yeah, I know. The amount of times I've actually gone into Walmarts and seen like Hutterites or Mennonites, like people that don't even drive cars that have like horse and buggy, for some reason they love shopping at Walmart in Canada.
Ah.
It's very strange.
Well, I don't see many Mennonites around here. I did when I lived in Ohio.
Ooh. You lived in Ohio?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Salina, Ohio, right?
Yeah, yeah. I lived in three different cities in Ohio.
See?
I lived in Salina twice.
Oh, okay.
So do you have any, amazing Radio Shack memories? You know,
no,
like
actually.
When you were back in the 70s, did you have a battery club card?
I didn't. But I just remembered a song that includes the words Radio Shack that you might want to play to end the show later.
What's that?
It's a Matthew Good song. I'm going to look it up.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll try and play that. Yeah, if you can give me the link, sure.
Yeah, I will.
Is it about Radio Shack or just mentions Radio Shack?
It just mentions the word Radio Shack.
Okay.
But actually, on second thought, it might not even be a wise idea. It was just association, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, never mind. But yeah, do you have any interesting Radio Shack stories, Brad?
No, not really. I bought lots of, you know what red boxes are?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I bought the crystal that you need to buy to modify your tone dialer.
Oh, the one that comes from the toaster?
Yeah, well, no, like back then we just, we bought them from Radio Shack.
And
we put them in our tone dialers.
I see. Did you ever do any return switcheroos?
Yes, I did. I remember specifically in a tone dialer, like I was so poor back then. It was like a $25 tone dialer to make a red box with. And I bought it and I took the innards out of it, you know, just the circuit board and stuff. And I filled up the casing with just like wood chips and glue.
Amazing.
And returned it. And
amazing.
Yeah, I think I ended up buying a second tone dialer.
Lucky you didn't buy the one you returned.
And then the circuit board, I enclosed it inside of an old Walkman and put like switches all over it. And it looked ridiculous. And it was stupid.
Brilliant. Stupid. That's brilliant. It would have been really funny if you did buy the one that you previously returned.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that would have been karma.
No, I went to a different store. I know better.
Very good. Very smart.
It weighed so much less, too.
Well, as we've all learned from your shows, people are incredibly stupid.
Oh, and there's this old hacker radio show from maybe 10 or 15 years ago. It was called Default Radio.
I remember it was called the what, sorry?
I think it was called Default Radio. I think that's the one it was. But they were talking about me on there once, and they said they ran my name in the Radio Shack computer, because I guess one of them worked there. And they saw like me buying crystals and stuff. They saw my history of crystal buying at all the Radio Shacks.
Dun, dun, dun. They put you on the Radio Shack watch list.
Yeah. Such a violation of my privacy when that happened.
I know.
It's like Nicki Minaj with the Papa John's recently. Or not Nicki what? Minaj. Not Nicki Minaj. Izzy. Izzy Azalea? Yeah, did you hear about that?
No, I didn't. Do tell.
She got a pizza delivered to her house from Papa John's.
Mm-hmm.
And then later, she started getting texts. And like, oh my God, I'm your number one fan. My brother delivered your pizza and he gave me your number. Can you talk to me, please?
Nice.
She's pissed and writing tweets about it.
I bet somebody got fired.
yeah, he did.
Nice.
That's pretty awesome, though, that happened.
Yeah, that's funny.
She's threatening to sue. So you want to talk to... Oh, wow, another old name. I think it's an old name. Eleanor?
Gertrude?
Eleanor. But she has an iPhone 5.
And she returned it?
Yeah, she returned her iPhone 5 iridescent case.
Oh, it was just a case.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And I think you need to have words with her.
Okay. Do you ever feel like just freestyling with a beat, you know, while you're waiting?
Yeah, freestyling about being on hold. Or,
yeah.
I love this part of the show.
Just whatever, just off the dome, whatever comes to mind. That could be a new thing to sort of break up the boringness of the ring.
That'd probably be awful. I don't think we want to try that. You can.
Oh, no, I was going to say, no, not me, but...
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic...
Mr. Clay says, Eleanor Rigby bought an iPhone on the 3rd of Sunday. What did she pay? Wait, is that the freestyle, Mr. Clay?
Oh, I don't know. That was good, actually. That was good. Okay, so that's what it should be. Someone in the chat should write the rap, and then you can rap it.
No, don't even suggest that. God damn it, Mr.
Perfect, Smart. Brad.
All right, you have to talk to this lady. Her name is Anna. And she purchased something called a Thunder Tumbler.
What is that?
I wonder... Well, I mean, it could be a Thunder connection for a Mac, maybe? I could have misunderstood what they said.
I get the picture of, like, a little Asian powerhouse gymnast. A Thunder Tumbler, you know?
That could be it. Maybe it's one of those things that goes in your cup holder in your car that has USB ports.
Okay, maybe. Well, we're going to find out.
Yeah, her name's Anna. You returned the Thunder Tumbler? What the fuck is that? Holy shit. Chat room.
Whoa, that Pioneer. Word's not allowed in here.
Oh, that would be an easy freestyle, though.
Hello?
Hello, is this Anna?
Speaking.
Hi, Anna. It's Kendra calling from Radio Shack Corporate Office. How you doing today?
Good, thank you.
Good. What you doing?
Coloring my hair.
Oh, what color? Anna? Anna?
She didn't like that at all.
What? I was trying to be nice. Trying to make conversation. Yeah. Sorry, I ruined that one.
No, it's bullshit. Like, you can't just be friendly with people anymore.
I know. You can call her back. And maybe it was just the female thing.
It's like the what you doing lady. She's like, nobody's ever asked me this before. I don't know what to do. This is the weirdest thing ever.
Well, at least she told me what she was doing.
Yeah. Am I taking this, or this is Anna again?
Yeah.
I might have to slap you again.
Your call has been forwarded to
fucking Anna.
Whatever you say, Mistress Arby.
Do you have any idea what an MHL cable is?
No idea.
I bet you I misunderstood that. That doesn't sound real. It sounds like football.
It's a Matt Hillock something or other.
That's got to be it.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice.
Oh, someone posted a link.
I see. The Thunder Tumbler apparently has god-awful reviews.
Let's see. I want to see what it is. It's a Black Series Thunder Tumbler remote-controlled monster car. Oh, I know what these are. I've dealt with these before. When I was doing mail-order catalogs, maybe, I remember someone bought one of
these. Are those the ones that, like, can flip all different directions? Like, four-wheel?
It looks like it, yeah.
Yeah. Oh yeah, 360-degree feature performs spins, jumps, wheelies, and other extreme stunts.
Yeah, they probably returned it because kids don't give a shit about stuff like that.
Yeah,
a remote control car, wow, neat.
I want a drone.
Welcome to the 1950s.
Well, at least it's not one of those do-it-yourself electronic wiring scientist kits, right?
Oh, those were awesome.
I do remember that.
I have bought those for my kids in the past, and, you know, they had like a day of, or an hour or two of fun. And
yeah, well, it gets their brain working at least.
Yeah, yeah.
Unlike most things these days.
You're like, oh, that's great, Dad. Time to play video games for 8 days straight. I loved those electronics kits when I was a kid.
Mm-hmm, from Radio Shack. Too.
Did you really? Or are you just?
No, I did. No, I'm not trolling. I really did.
Wow.
Kind of dorky like that.
Did you have the ones that just snap together, or did they have the springs?
No, I distinctly remember. I think one had something to do with radio. Like you could turn. Like you, I ended up making wiring something together, and it was like AM radio or something.
Yeah, and then you make it, and it's like, well, what do I do with this?
Yeah, what do I do now? Listen to crappy, static-filled AM radio.
Yep. Listen to some talk shows.
But at least you get a sense of accomplishment, like you actually built something.
Yeah, know? Yeah, it was neat. And building, like, you know, AM radio broadcasters and stuff with those. I had the kind that you it had the springs on it, and you had to, you know, just stick the wires under the springs.
Oh, stick the wire in, yeah, yeah. Yep.
The ones I got for my kids, they were just, they snapped together. They looked like buttons. You just
snap, oh, really?
Snap the buttons together.
Oh, yeah, mine wasn't that simple. Yeah,
we still have it.
You know, you can create some sort of, like, live... It's a similar thing, but you can actually do it just by drawing on a piece of paper with, like, a lead pencil.
Oh, yeah. Or those silver pins that do the really shiny silver stuff.
Oh, really? That works, too?
Maybe. I don't know, actually. Oh.
Well, I know for sure you can do it with lead pencil. I saw a YouTube video. It's pretty cool. You can actually, like, turn a light bulb on.
You can write your name with a lead pencil and then put a lead on each side.
And then
side.
Connect, like, two or a battery and a wire and then light a light bulb.
Okay, stop. I'm getting hard.
Circuitry! Yay!
I don't think she heard that, everyone.
I did.
All right.
I did. That's all I hear all day.
We're almost done. There's, like, one left after this.
Oh, no.
Hello?
Hi, Damien? Hey, it's Roy from the Radio Shack.
From where?
From the Radio Shack. You returned a HDMI cable to us.
Oh, yeah.
But I guess you probably know why we're calling, don't you?
Nope.
Really? We're going to be like this?
Huh?
We're going to be like this, really?
I don't know. Why are you calling?
Okay, let me put Kendra on, because I'm sure she's got something to say to you.
Hi there. Is this the Damien I was hearing about?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yeah. It's Kendra calling from corporate office. I was just calling in regards to the return that you made the other day. I was just inquiring as to why you bought the item and then returned it. Seems a little bit pointless.
Why I bought it?
Yeah, why did you buy it only to return it later? Seems kind of counterproductive.
Because it was the wrong cord.
Well, why did you buy the wrong cord? That seems a little dumb. Wait, why didn't you look to see what kind of cord you needed before you went out and bought it?
Wait. So you're calling me and you're telling me that's kind of fucking dumb.
Well, I didn't say, I don't calling believe I said fucking dumb. But do you understand, sir, that we're closing more than half of our stores because of incidents like this?
No, I know, but you, as a customer, I mean, a worker from Radio Shack, calling me and telling me
I'm a manager, sir.
Kind of dumb. What?
I'm a manager, not just a worker. That's quite insulting.
Okay, so why are you using that kind of language? I'm a fucking manager.
I don't believe
too.
I said fucking. I believe that you're lying about that.
I said, yeah, I'm saying fucking, but you calling me and telling me,
please don't use that language, sir.
Because it was dumb. Because it was dumb.
Well, it kind of was a little dumb, you have to admit.
It was pretty dumb.
Well, yeah, it was kind of fucking dumb, but that was the wrong cord.
Well, maybe you should have figured out what cord you needed, don't you think? Dumb, ignorant, stupid?
Why don't you plan ahead, stupid?
Come on.
You know what? Fuck.
Do you understand how many employees we have that are now out of work because of stupid dum-dums like you?
Hello?
What?
As a manager, you don't call people up and telling them, oh, why did you buy this cord? Don't you think it was kind of dumb?
Well, it was.
How do you think the person would feel if you're telling them that kind of stupid stuff?
Probably pretty dumb.
Exactly. So why you gotta fucking?
Exactly. Well, that's what I'm trying to. I'm trying to get that across to you. I'm glad it's working.
As a manager from Radio Shack.
Damien, I'm only going to be a manager for another week.
A manager from Radio Shack using that kind of language, calling up the people just to figure out, don't you think that's kind of
dumb? Hey, don't yell at Kendra, motherfucker.
No, you don't hear me.
Motherfucker.
You calling me.
Don't yell at Kendra.
You're the one that was using the bad language. I was just simply telling you that what you did was a waste of everyone's time.
The word fuck, but you calling me and telling me why did I buy this cord? Don't you think that's kind of dumb?
Well,
don't you think that's kind of dumb to use that kind of language to customers?
Why didn't you plan ahead?
I didn't use the language, sir. That was you that included the F word in your speech, not me.
Okay,
I was just simply telling you what you were doing was just counterproductive and dumb.
Don't you think that's kind of dumb?
No, well, it's something a stupid ignorant would do.
Don't you think I'm not supposed to be feeling offended?
Well, I didn't say you weren't supposed to be feeling offended, sir. How do you think the 50,000 employees of Radio Shack feel? They can't feed their families this spring.
Because of you.
What is the whole point of you calling me and telling me what? Why did I buy this?
Well, I'm hoping that you won't repeat the same mistake again.
That is my problem, but that's not your problem to be calling up customers and telling them, don't you think that's kind of dumb?
Well, Damien, it kind of becomes our problem when we have to lay off all of our staff.
Do you think that's right? Calling up a customer and telling them, because you bought this, don't you think that's dumb?
Well, what would you call it? Would you call it smart?
That's not the point of dumb or smart. You got to choose your words right.
I'm choosing them very, very right, Damien.
Why did you buy this card? Why did you return it just moments later? Don't you think that's dumb?
Well, what?
Don't you think that's dumb for using that kind of language?
As I've already explained, I don't think I'm the dumb one here.
As a fucking manager, do you...
Please don't use that language,
sir. Do you think that's smart? Do you think that's smart for using that kind of words?
Please don't use that language.
Okay, then you don't use that language and call me and telling me, don't you think that's dumb?
Because please don't raise your voice with Kendra.
Dumb.
Kendra hasn't raised her voice with you.
Who gives a shit?
Would you like me to put my manager on the phone?
Who the fuck is Kendra?
What was that?
You guys calling me, hey asshole, listen, you guys fucking calling me.
Yes, that's
correct. You guys calling me, I never call you. No, you guys calling me and telling me, don't you think that's dumb?
Okay, well, what would you call it? Wouldn't you say that person was dumb?
You fucking call a customer and tell a customer, why did you buy this card? Don't you think it's dumb?
Okay, well, what would you call it, Damien?
I wouldn't call it dumb.
What would you call it, then? Tell me, what would you call it, Damien?
Okay, listen, shut up and listen, let me explain. I would have said, you buying this card, there was no need to buy this card, you should have bought this. Do you think that's dumb?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she didn't raise her voice, but it was the way how she said it. And as a manager, you don't go up into a customer and say, don't you think that's dumb?
Well, I already did. And do you understand? Have you been out of work before? Have you had to try to scrape together the funds to feed your family? We're laying off more than half of our staff because of dumb customers like you.
I bust my ass to feed six kids, okay? I bust my ass every day. I work.
How many moms?
Bust my ass for six kids.
And how many different moms for those kids? 7.5?
15, 16, 12, 13, and 11.
Oh, okay. I don't think that's what I asked, but don't you think that you could have... Damien, please listen. I'm trying to help you here. Had you done a little bit of research, then you could have saved the time that you took to return the items and spent it with your 15 million kids.
Basically, you're a bad father.
First of all, don't be sassy and be, you're 15 million kids.
You're a bad father.
You see how you are. You're fucking sassy.
You're a bad father.
I am sassy. I'm a sassy, sassy pants girl.
Exactly. So as customer service on customer fucking whatever the fuck you're claiming you are,
I got the head. I got the top customer service award.
Why do you have to talk to people that
way? I got the head customer service award 3 months in a row, Damien.
Why do you have to talk to people that way?
Yes, I did. And I'm not sorry.
Okay, so why? What was the whole point? You saying these words could have not saying these words could have alleviated this whole
Did I hurt your feelings?
Process.
Did I hurt your feelings, Damien? I'm sorry. Actually, no, I'm not sorry. Toughen up.
Okay, yeah. You see how you are? No, I'm sorry. Oh, no, I'm not.
I told you I was sassy.
You're claiming you're a manager?
I agreed with you. I'm a manager, for another week.
Okay, so why do you speak that way?
Because...
As a manager.
Because I'm trying to communicate to you in hopes that you don't make
this
mistake again.
You're right, but you're telling people they're fucking dumb. Oh, I'm taking that back. Sorry, you didn't say
it's
F word.
It's tough love,
you're calling
Damien.
People dumb. You don't use that kind of language. You don't call people dumb.
Well, I did.
Where are you from? Are you from Hawaii?
I'm not from Hawaii. I'm not a coconut
okay,
head. Do I sound like a coconut head?
You don't Hawaii people that way. You don't talk to people like that. You're not from Hawaii. You fucking customer service. You're stupid.
What? You're stupid.
You're stupid. You customer service, calling me, telling me, why did I buy this HDMI cord? And are you telling me I'm dumb?
How many times are we going to have to go
because
over
this?
This
cord?
Until
no,
you
shut
get
the
it.
Fuck up. That's basically what you said.
That is what I said.
Dumb? Yeah, exactly. So where are you from? The mainland? You fucking
I'm not,
stupid.
I told you, I'm not a coconut
head. You don't talk to Hawaii people that way, you dumb bitch.
What are you going to do
you
about it, coconut
stupid.
Head?
Shut the fuck up.
Make me.
No, call me and give me this bullshit.
Bullshit. What are you going to do about it,
yeah,
Damien?
Yeah, this bullshit. You see how you're acting, Kendra, manager of Radio Shack.
That's right.
Telling me because I bought an HDMI cord, a wrong cord, to return it, to buy something else, and then I'm dumb?
Okay, Damien, ask your kids. Hey, kids, would you rather have daddy spent some time with you, or would you rather that daddy was a dumb-dumb and bought the cord he didn't need?
Who cares about the fucking kids? That's not
I
your
do.
Problem.
Apparently, you don't. Maybe you should care
That's
a little bit more
your
about your
problem.
Kids and you stop making
Did
dumb
you
choices.
You think the kids out of your own pussy? No, shut the fuck up. That's not your problem. Put the kids out of the picture.
Maybe you should care about your kids more and stop being a bad father.
Have you met the kids? Do you know what they look like? Do you see the clothes that they're wearing? Do you see what school they go to? Do you see what electronics they have on them? And I'm a bad person?
Probably crappy ones because you don't know what
Kendra
to buy.
Kendra from Radio Shack in Kapolei, you stupid.
You
don't call people for go calling people and say, oh, why did you buy this cord? Because you're dumb.
It's a pretty dumb decision. That's the last time I'm going to say it, Damien.
No, it's a dumb decision for you to be calling somebody in Hawaii because they bought a cord and then now it doesn't fit, so they went back to return it to get something else. And by the way, that's not your money.
You know what you probably did? You know what you probably did? You probably returned
it
once you realized you couldn't afford all your child support payments. Is that what happened?
Basically, you're calling me up just to give me shit. You calling me up to give me shit. You calling me up for telling me I dumb for buying a cord, for returning it, and purchasing something else. Basically, that's what it is.
Are your feelings hurt, Damien?
Is
Sometimes
that what
the
it
truth
is?
Hurts.
Is that what you're calling me up for?
That's what I'm calling you for, yes, Damien.
So basically, you're calling me up to tell me I'm stupid. Or
We've gone over
that
this. Acceptance
word.
Is
I'm
the first step.
For buying
step.
A cord,
Quit repeating yourself,
for returning
Damien.
It,
Come on.
And in purchasing something else.
Damien, shut the fuck up.
Oh, now you're telling me shut the fuck
up. No, that was me. That wasn't Kendra.
Radio Shack fucking workers telling me to shut the fuck up. With you guys called me telling me why I bought the cord. Why did I return it? Why did I buy something else? And don't you think that's dumb? And then I'm supposed to be all happy and smiling for you?
Damien,
fuckers?
Listen, I'm also not a native of Hawaii. Make sure that pisses you off. Oh, he's gone. I ruined it. He got really angry when he found out you weren't a native Hawaiian.
That's great.
Like, he did not like that at all.
No.
They apparently, they really hate outsiders.
Oh, that was the best. That was
he's going to go home and beat his kids now. Look what you caused.
Oh, man. Oh, those good coconut heads. They're always good for a laugh.
That was a really good last call to do, but I'm still going to do this one last one that's left from my list.
You don't want to call him back? Try to reason with him?
Okay. Why not?
You don't have to. I'm scared, personally.
You should be. Damien sounds like someone you don't mess with.
Yeah.
I'm surprised he didn't say, do you know who you're messing with?
Damien's another word for devil.
Hey, Damien. We got disconnected somehow. Damien?
It's not Damien, but, I mean, he's really pissed off for now, and I'm siding with him because I see no reason why you should call back, because that's not his business.
Are you one of his 12 kids?
A customer buys and what a customer returns.
Are you one of his 12 kids?
One of his 12 kids? No, I'm not one of his 12. What does it matter about his 12 kids? Exactly, you see how they are?
Listen, hey.
Hello?
How many different mothers?
Hey, listen, man, you know, what does Radio Shack stand by in customer service? I mean, what's his boss?
What the fuck do we care? We're going out of business.
What the fuck do you care, huh?
Yeah, we're
I'm gonna come over there and lick you right now, you fucker.
Nah, I'm locking the store.
No, lock your faggot. What? No threatening them. No threatening them. They're fucking punk.
You can't come in.
Don't threaten my manager.
He's gone.
Ugh.
Oh no.
Oh my god.
That was scary.
Yeah. He can't come to the phone. He's really angry right now. He totally probably just like socked one of his kids, punched him right in the jaw.
Let's hope. He probably has his kids on his machine. My daddy can't come to the phone right now.
Woo.
That was crazy. He's going to tell so many people that story.
He doesn't seem like the type that knows how to type extremely well, but if he did, I bet he'd write a bad review.
Please leave your message for 80.
Oh, come on.
Oh, come on.
I'm going to try one more time.
Are you siding with Damien, Brad?
No. I was saying, come on.
After what he said to me?
No. God damn it. Quit being like that toward me. Just be like that toward the prank callers. Jeez.
Just got to have your loyalties, Brad. Come on. I defended you.
I know. I'm sorry.
I would defend you to the death and buy you all the ice cream in the world.
Well, I guess that's it. Should we try and close down one more store? I think, like, it's been 4 hours.
I think you should. Yeah.
This is a really long show.
That's a good thing. It's to make up for all those shows.
Hey, everyone. This counts as all of my shows for the week, by the way.
Yep. Yeah, I second that.
Yeah.
If
I don't do any more shows this week, that's my excuse.
It's stamped approved by Mistress Morgan.
Pick a state. Any state.
Guam
or province.
Or Hawaii.
Oh, Hawaii, okay.
I sent you a link with all the Hawaii stores.
Oh, too late. I just look on Google Maps and just click on them. But thank you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to go to the one island that I didn't get customer numbers from.
You can do this.
We'll see. Do I have to keep going until I actually succeed?
Yeah, why not? Gives you incentive.
Whoa. Hello?
Hello?
Fusion, hello?
Hi, can you hear me?
Oh, yeah, this is Greg from the corporate office. You could probably tell because I said that word.
Oh.
From the Radio Shack corporate office?
Yes.
Fusion.
How can I help you?
Oh, how come you're open today? You were supposed to... Yesterday was the last day for your location there.
In Kalokona?
Yeah. Your store was supposed to close. You shouldn't be there. You're not helping customers, are you? Fusion?
Hold on one second.
Okay, Fusion. Fusion?
Hold on one second. I can talk to my manager.
Fusion.
Thanks for holding. This is Cuz.
Oh, hello. This is David from the corporate office with Radio Shack.
Okay. And what's the password?
A Fusion.
Let's see. Okay.
Okay, what?
Okay, yeah. You're correct.
Oh, yes. I am correct. Okay, yeah. So, are you helping customers today? Like, are you still open?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah, your store is supposed to close. Like, yesterday. Yesterday was the last day.
Okay.
Yeah, you should.
But how come we didn't get any notification?
Oh, you should have. Your district manager didn't give it to you?
Nope, and we're still getting all this cycle count.
It's really hard to hear you. Can you put the microphone by your mouth?
Hold on just a minute. Let me finish ringing this customer up.
Oh, no. You have to tell them to go. Like, you can't ring up any more customers. Tell them your store's closed permanently and they have to go. And any other customers that are in there, they have to go.
Yeah, but we're not part of those stores that are supposed to be.
Oh, no, you are now. No, you were put on the list over a month ago.
No, because the most recent list I seen was just a few days ago.
Don't argue with the corporate office. You're closed. You really have to tell that customer to go. You can't ring up any more sales.
and that's just us?
Yeah, yeah, just your location. You're the only one in Hawaii right now. On that island, I mean.
And how many on Oahu?
Oh, I don't even have that list with me. I just know that yours shouldn't be open, and someone just called and said that you were still doing sales. Did you tell the customer to leave yet?
No, I got a few of them that I got to finish up with, and that's it.
Oh, could you quickly just tell them to leave the store? I can hold while you tell them to leave the store.
Okay, just a minute.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm just trying to get a hold of my DM because I have no information whatsoever.
Oh, okay. Did you get rid of the customers?
There's only two more. There's one that we were dealing with a phone issue, so
it's not that
easy to just get rid of them.
Oh, no, you just tell them to leave. So this store is closing permanently. You have to leave. You have to get rid of them right now.
No,
we can't ring up any more sales.
Phone.
Huh?
We have their phone.
Okay, well, give them their phone back. Just tell them they have to go.
What was your name again?
Roy Gerbel from the corporate office.
Say it again?
Roy Gerbel from the corporate office.
Roy Gerbel?
Yes, from the corporate office. Look, sir, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, so as punishment for being open today, because you've been open for hours now, you need to punch yourself in the balls. I want you to punch yourself in the balls two times.
Wouldn't be speaking like this to me.
Oh, I am. I can do what I want. I'm the corporate office. So don't tell me how to speak. Don't tell me how to do my job. You don't even know how to do your job. You're supposed to be closed. So I want you to punch yourself in the balls two times. Nope. I guess he's gone. I guess.
That was rude.
I know. That was taking forever. That was so boring. Lucky for the podcast listeners, I'll be editing all that silence away. I bet it'll be in like an hour of silence edited out at the end of the show.
That will be saved for the special once a year show of yep. Silence and Rings.
Yep, exactly.
Yeah.
I think I'm about finished.
Well, Dust Bernadette agrees, so.
Oh, okay. No, I was going to say let's call three more stores, but Dust Bernadette says time to go.
Stupid.
End it, please. So, okay, Dust Bernadette.
But Alki says, shopping spree, 3 exclamation marks.
Nope, Dust Bernadette has seniority over Alki.
Oh.
Sorry, Alki.
Ouch.
I really want to do this again, this whole Radio Shack thing again.
You got to. It's wonderful.
I want to do it constantly until they're...
Until you get bored of it.
Until they're all gone.
Then back to banks.
Yep, back to banks. Banks and pharmacies. I want to get pharmacy personal information and bank and personal information.
Oh, a pharmacy. That's a good idea. Have you done that before?
No, it's really illegal.
Oh, well, okay. I guess there's
like specific laws for banks and pharmacies.
Yeah, I guess so. Well, you've ignored the bank ones, right?
No, because that's different. That's I'm not getting bank information from people.
Oh, okay.
It's you can't call up a bank or a pharmacy and ask for information.
Oh, yeah, I guess so.
Actually, okay. I'm probably wrong. I'm probably just breaking laws with that whole bank thing.
Well, you know what you should do that I really miss? The Meridian calls.
Meridian?
Or the sponsor of whatever it's called. The Meridian thing. What the hell is it called? You know what I'm talking about.
Is this a Canadian word?
It might be the Canadian word for what your show was. You remember the things in the middle of the road where like the plane crashed and they're going pot?
Oh, Median.
What? Median. Okay. Meridian and median are the same thing. I think those are synonyms.
Oh, I've never heard of meridian for that.
Oh, really?
I mean, but, do you seriously, is that the common name for them?
I'm
meridian?
Pretty sure, yeah.
Huh. Weird. Yeah. I've never heard that.
Now you know.
This show is so educational.
I know.
Well, anyway, I'm going to get going.
All right. It's been a blasty blast,
yeah,
as always. Thank you, Fred.
You're the best Radio Shack coworker ever.
Thanks, buddy. You're the best Radio Shack manager ever.
I hope we can keep in touch once we go bankrupt.
I sure hope so. Yep. Roy Gerbel, the biggest jerk ever.
Yep. That's me. Yep.
Well, it was nice knowing you, buddy.
Okay. You too.
Radio Shack out.
Bye.
Bye.
Mistress Morgan's the best. Okay, you guys, today's show is brought to you by Devin Gladden. He's the sponsor of today's show. Thank you, Mistress Morgan, for being on the Devin Gladden show. And I guess Carlito, even though you left early. But thank you for being on the show, Carlito. It was a lot of fun. What else? Yeah, that's it. I've still got a big list of customers here, so these will definitely be used again. I mean, you know, I'll give them a try again on a future show. It's gonna be hilarious. We're gonna end with emergency pizza party. Bye, everyone.